not just any ranger, not by a long shot.
Alright, what's good? We are live with some Battle for the Grid. We have a good fun time with this new tournament that we've got ready for you. We've got quite a fun bracket. Let's see if we can spot it. Hey, Rocket. Win the capture shirt, yeah. Alright, nice. So we got a nice bracket set up for today. Keyboard Fighter, Kaiser, Karen, Rocket Punch, Bob, myself, Spaghetti, Joel, and Demon's there joining in today. We've got people coming, Spaghetti joining in all the way from South Africa, Joel joining from Libya. Should be a fun time. Once I confirm that everyone is around, you can get ready. Right. Hey Jack, hope you're doing well. Let me just make sure that everybody is here. I think for the first match I'm going to go and get Keyboard Bite Fighter and Jeef to play. Just me tonight, dude. Falcon same. I've been exhausted like for the last month. That's been pretty bad these last couple of days. I believe in you, Jeef. You've been improving. I've not played in a while, but last time I did, you managed to never set off me. I believe. Which should be. Yeah, it's best of five, Rocket. Obviously, grid matches run fast, and therefore it's good to get as many in as possible. future. We've hit time now, so I'm going to start up a bracket. Yeah, if people want to get their matches running, they can get their matches running. Let me just double check if Jarl is here. Has he made it? Back in here, we've got Rocket Punch, Keyboard Fighter. Okay, yeah, so I'm going to start off a bracket. Again, if you want to just run your matches while you can, feel free to. Let me think. So we've got Keyboard and Jeef, and Bob. Yeah, so I think I'm going to get Keyboard Fighter and Jeef in the first match, and then I'm going to get Rocket Punch and Bob. Just get them to start out with. But yeah, since we've got those, we just need to wait on Jeef to turn up and then we will be ready. Yeah, you and Bob run it off stream for now. Yeah, I can do. Let me just move it a bit closer first and foremost and turn it up. Yeah, okay. About any better? Okay, we've got Jeef and we've got Keyboard Fighter in. I'm going to go into Spectate. And we're going to get this watching going. Right, first match of the tournament. Get a good fun one. Enjoy playing both these players. Both all about the combos. Both prepping the Lauren. Let's see how this runs. Got a nice dog. Trying to set the assist there, but got tagged by Lauren's range. No one on commentary gaming. It's just me for the time being. If people want to hop on, just send me a message. I'm fine too. But there you go. On the pressure with Jen. Not much avail yet, but opening up a tray. And we got Lauren combos going. In we go. Flame corridor loops. It's going to be a kill. It should be. It's got the meter to do it. Yeah, Grim, if you want to help on to commentary, send me a message, we can and get you on after this. Hey, Mr. Fox. You've got the Eric doing his neutral thing. Drops the combo, but back in again with the overhead cross up. Catching the Eric, and that's going to be dead. Now he gets interesting, avoiding using incoming, but rather backs off and decides just to use the flame carpet to open them up that way. It works, I guess. Let's go. Managed to miss that, but Keyboard Fighter taking the first set of that match. Convincingly running it with the Lauren there, getting all the kills. Yeah. Let's see if this pans out. We have the unusual experience of Jar has actually, I think, made it. Right, we've got Trey opening up the Volova. There we go. In we go. Oh, G's got these stylish gold leaves down. Really weird ones where you just do the interesting cross up there. I think I've seen Starrich do those. But now we can go into the gold lightning leaves. There we go. That should lead into super. That should be death. Trey does this with ease. Oh no, but the drop, that's a rare one. I've not seen it drop that often like that. I've seen it drops quite easily on Trini, but I've not seen him do much. You see, it's interesting that he could have done a lot more because he managed to land a 6M, which is plus a block. Here we go. Shadow Assist is so good at closing the gap there, but the tag in was a bit unfortunate because he was out there swinging. Trace 2L, even though it's not for a great range, is quite quick. Okay, here we go. Ooh, very laggy projectile there. Got Quantum Guns. Again, Jeep is picking a lot of the really laggy projectile options at a bit of an opportune range, but managing to convert anyway. We've got an Eric combo here. Should be a kill. Oh no, and as I say about commentator's curse, drops the combo. He's looking a bit cold here, dropping a lot of quantum stuff. So, there we go. That'll do it. Dead Eric, and now he's left with Lauren, but as we've seen, Lauren can pull out a lot of fun stuff. But he's got... Oh, nice. That's going to be eating up that Zord timer. Keeper Fight will probably manage to get another Zord in through this. In this match, but... Jeef really should be popping Zord soon, I think, because... That meter is just sitting there, and as soon as he gets tagged, it's going to start going away. Needs to find a time to put this pressure on and make this comeback happen. Oh. Alright, random EX will do it. Here we go. There is the gold R2 pressure. Let's see, can he convert? Keyboard is just blocking and being careful here. It seems to be doing well for him. So there we go. Interesting, doesn't quite have the source yet, but
I saw that coming from a mile away.
Okay. That's some discover combos. That should be a dead dog, and it looks like that's gonna be an easy rip. Nice comeback with Lauren. Lauren showing off that she's a really good character. Alright, taking it 1-1, and see how this goes. Okay, what we got here? Let's get this incoming. Incoming? Round stop. I don't know what words are. Okay, so... Got some neutral being played and ignored by Lauren. This is the fun times of playing Battle for the Grid. And Keyboard Fighter has shown he can get these combos here with Lauren. They're easy to kill here. Trey not having the most health in the first place and Lauren having crazy damage. Again, commentator's curse as it happens. Okay, manages to dodges the projectile but goes into the happy birthday situation. Does Jeef have these happy birthday conversions here? Oh, he does. That's definitely a much more friendly happy birthday, Luke. Ooh, but this is the conversion after the stay there. Ooh, ends up on the unsafe EX. That's not right. Ooh, get some of the immediate HR incoming. Keep all fighter pressing buttons there. Something you've got to be really careful of in pressing buttons on incoming, as it can sometimes work if the opponent has an unsafe incoming option. But if the opponent has something that counteracts it, then you're going to get tagged and will probably lead to death, so you have to be very, very careful of how you do it and how you play it. Play slicing at his legs. Not getting it. Oh, the Trey grab. Technically footsie special right there. Trey's grab, front up grab, is actually really good. As anybody who plays me really knows, because I go for that all too much. You get a lot of range off it, and it grab in this game is generally just very good because it beats out a load of options. Ooh, looking like he's going to chip out the dog, but the assist manages to take up on the damage. Just needs to get a bit of chip in there. And there we go, there's the dog down. But Jen, ooh, does he get the conversion off this? Nice. Airblade is still a very good challenge option. But Jen just dropping out the combo, and then Jen coming in is rough for sure on the side of G. Jen's definitely not going to be fun to deal with. Really needs to watch out for the incoming missile. Oh no, tragic. Again, pressing buttons on incoming. Definitely not a good idea if Zord's out. Now, ooh, interesting. I was going to say, Jen could probably kill off that. But I don't think he quite was there yet. He could have gone for a reset as well, but still clutching out with Jen. Jen is a very good character just to run in with, and Evil Fighter is taking it 1 point up. Cool move. Alright, Rocket takes the game. Nice. We're here on the last match of this. Lauren starting off the flame carpet. Okay, here we go. Little flame corridor, we got dog assist. You've got to be careful with Lauren, with Jen rather, when she's on the other side of you, because at that point you cannot hit her, you cannot really hit the assist, so the missiles are going to be guaranteed to come, so you always got to adjust your combo, stop it short. Just so you don't get tagged by the Jen missiles and then get locked into another combo. Ooh, there we go. Try to do the run and grab, but keep quite knows new to jump up. Very nicely done there. Not finishing it though. Really leaving Jeep on a lot of blue life left to recover, and that's going to be really great for Jeep's Megazord meter. Evil Fighter really needs to end things right now and work quickly. Hey, here we go. Again, dropping combos every now and then. I've not played not much Lauren, but I've noticed that drop a fair few times. I think you just gotta be a bit careful of how it hits with a ground bounce. I'm sure for actual Lauren players, you will know more about that. Hits him with a knee. Ooh, misses the easy trade conversion off of that. going to get really badly punished for it. Managed to get the chip. It was really a battle of who was going to get the chip first. And oh, Heath is living on tiny bits of life here. You don't want to leave Trey alive, because Trey can just run away with things if you let him. Heath has, ooh, a nice little thing there, but sadly drops. Ooh. Now we see Jeep has got some more happy birthday friendly routes from some trays, so. Okay, there goes the round bounce. There you go, VX getting the last bit of chip needed. So Dog is in chip range as well. Now if I were Keeper Fighter, I'd want to get the kill, set up a Megazord thing, and tag out just so that you get that blue life back and around chip range from Dog. You've still got the ran out of Zord for neutral, but now Jeep is left on the Lauren and it's not looking good. Jeep is calling out Megazord in neutral. Oh, nice little jump over the flame carpet. Nice punish. Good stuff there from Keyboard Fighter taking it. 3-1. Good stuff. Alright, so I think next, if they're not playing, I'm going to try and get Spaghetti and Jarl into play. Because Jarl has made it to the tournament for the first time since we started running these things. I think he's tried playing every single time and not managed to get in. But that was a nice little set there. We'll get the scores in. 3-1 to Keyboard Fighter. The Rocket Punch took it. 3-0 over Bob. Jarl was in the lobby. Okay, great, never mind. I thought he was in the lobby already. Never you mind. Okay, Jarl and Spaghetti, come on in. Get this match running. You might be against me, I've not checked. Let me see. Yeah, you are, Rocket. Right, Kaiser has asked to be EQ'd, so I'm gonna. My Kaiser. Okay, I'll just see if we get Karim in here to do some commentary. Just need to wait for Jarl to hop in against Spag. Hey, Karim.
Cool, cool.
Set up the scoreboard for Jarl and Spag. If you want to hop in on Spectator Room, should be able to get this going. Excellent. Load. Here we go. Got a connection. Let's get this running.
Okay, so Spag's running Lauren, was it Doggy and Ranger Slayer?
Yep. And and Jarl is running Red Gold Odon, and Jarl playing for the first time in a Ranger Rumble tournament.
Yeah.
The curse
very
is broken.
Surprising. Yeah. He was just waiting for there to be like little entrance before he finally entered, I think. he wanted to best his chances.
Maybe.
But let's see what he's got to offer. Well, we're getting Red Ranger doing some damage right now.
Ooh, manages to use one launcher too many there. But we're right back into a combo.
Picked up the assist.
Nice OTG.
He meant off it. Okay, still got the assist, but can he still confirm the double? No. Oh, nice Adana. Well, I don't want to say nice Adana as if it's Adana at the end of the day, but he managed to catch something nonetheless.
Yeah, but you don't want to catch out Spag. He's probably one of the best dog players we've got here, so.
Never actually seen him play. The only dog player I know is Richmond, to be honest, in the EU.
Oh, yeah. And Spag is South Africa, I think.
Oh, Golden managed to get the body splat.
Always really ambiguous. I think Joel's hitting Spag with a lot of just random stuff at the moment. Well, not random stuff, but he's kind of catching him.
Him and the assist.
Yeah.
Oh, but we're about to see Lauren doing Lauren things.
Yeah. Spag's got quite a nice Lauren. I played quite a long set of him yesterday. He likes to go for the swap strikes quite a lot, which is always good because it. Especially at this time, because at this stage in a match, I think, because it starts denying Megazord Meteor, you're not really going to get back easily.
Oh, okay, Golda dropped out.
We've got Weezo.
Dead Udana.
Yeah, Spag's got these easily.
Oh, commentator's cursed at its finest.
It's fine, we get the gold off fist. Finishing things off, doesn't use the last bit of the second Megazord mark.
Goldar still sitting on his Mega Goldar. Is he going to go straight into God?
That's a really unfortunate tech. Lauren's hitbox is really weird on certain characters, so Goldar's sweep into anti-air grab doesn't actually work on her.
Yeah, I saw that when she first launched. That's a shame, he should have gone straight into Zord in my opinion there, just put her out of the way.
Yeah, but Spag taking that first one.
Yep.
One now. Yeah. Oh, let me come out. That's going to be on enter.
Oop, Giles jumped out. Let's see what's happened there.
See in the chat.
Seems to have popped out. Give him a sec.
Yeah, give him a couple minutes.
Maybe Giles gone out again. He has one match in the tournament.
Maybe he had one of his infamous power cuts.
And then the next tournament we'll get two matches. I'll get up from there.
He'll
build up slowly.
In a month's time.
Well, let's see if we can get that sorted. I don't know who's the African gaming experience. That's true, Spag. We've got pretty sure Joel is sort of Northern Africa. So we've got North and South at the moment.
He does not seem to be active anywhere.
Well, he's not been active. I don't know. Don't know what's going on. if he doesn't come back, oh.
Yeah, 25 past now, so how long do you want to give him before DQ?
See if I can get a hold of him. Yeah, it might be a power cut. Yeah.
The Power Ranger, the grid's too strong for his, for his loathsome electricity.
Evidently. It's overloading the circuitry.
Overloading the grid.
Indeed. Okay, let's see. While we wait to get a response from Jarl, I think next up I'll play against Rocket Punch, I think, next.
Okay, cool.
We can put it on hold for just a sec. But yeah, I'll give him another 5 minutes, and then I'll go for win to Spag.
Yeah, you can always run the match in winners whilst we're waiting for.
Yeah. So yeah, for now I think I'm gonna try and I'll put that match on hold. One Spag is 1-0 up, and I'll run a match with Joel, with Rocket Punch, and hopefully we'll get something going there.
I think if it was any other player, he would have got DQ'd, but the fact it's Joel,
you've got to feel bad for the guy, because he's legitimately tried to enter every single tournament. But
he's getting the sympathy time right now.
It's yeah.
So yeah, Rocket, if you want to jump in the match against Footsies, and I'll commentate that.
Okay. Yeah, we'll wait and see if Joel comes back. If he doesn't, rip. Well, at least he got one game in.
One to remember. And to be fair, he put in a good show as well.
Yeah, it was definitely a close match. Let's get this going.
Okay, so we have what I like to call Team Rushdown, which Rocket likes to play, or RJ, Tommy, and Lord Rapper, versus Footsies. Oh, Footsies goes with the Zed Star to begin with. Oh, he catches the classic Trey grab, and let's see what he can make of it. If you guys want to check the news feeds or anything, this is the time to do it, because this trade combo is going to be lost in a while. Now we should be going into the pyramid scheme. Get those zoop zoops on. Get the boot. Oh, and he manages to cash in. That was an unfortunate takeover into the grab by Trey. And we're going to see it all over again. Oh, no, an unfortunate... Oh, the EX incinerate. But Zed Assist managed to keep him safe. Okay, RJ's managed to clip. That should be a dead Trey. Neat of us as well. Oh, nice. He wants to just start with Draken. Oh, nice incoming with the teleport overhead. Drop. Oh, Tommy assist, you never know where it's gonna go. Okay, that's a bit direct on. Gotta watch your feet when you're playing against Daishi. He just wants Tommy dead. Let's see the star with Footsies, TODs on board. Doritos for days. Finish off with the slide. Oh, Zed said, watch your feet, because I'm coming in. Footsies is gonna go for his EX, I imagine. Yeah, that's a dead RJ. 1-0 to Footsies.
Okay, so Joel's whole game froze, apparently.
Fair enough. Well, at least he's still in there.
As long as he's still in there, I'm happy to... I'll run the set with Rocket, and then... We can get Joel's bag back in.
Yeah, it's great.
Good that he's back. Good that he's not dead.
Yeah.
He can still play.
Well, I wouldn't go as far as dead. Like, his capabilities are still running.
Yeah.
I don't think his mortality was ever in question. Okay, game two. Oh... Draken said I'm coming in, but Daishi said I'm over here. We are just getting lots of mess on the screen right now. Oh, and RJ's been clipped along with Draken, but he manages to fall out, and Daishi is going in on Draken. And will he EX to kill? Yes. That should kill? Yes. Okay, Trey takeover. But Tommy manages to get him. Oh, what combo is... Oh, Yeah, I get Tommy jump so much with inputs. It's crazy when you want to do S forward, but you get up forward. Just everyone's throwing out EXs, a bit of. Play. Okay, we've gone to some on this neutral now, and I say that, and RJ comes in with a jumping punch. Now RJ's just gonna remind. Oh, okay, straight into super. I was gonna say RJ's gonna remind everyone why he was the best character last patch. Trade's gonna come in. Yep. I would go into Zord if I was you. Oh, he does not need it. Saved by the Daishi Orb. Very good use of the stomp with Dragon Zord. It's not going to drop. I think Rocket would get so much more use if he used Dino Megazord there instead of Dragon Zord. It's getting some good neutral right now with Daishi versus Tommy. Orb still managed to go into the orb. Should have gone with a 4S there with Tommy instead of EX. Ooh, where is. Whoa! That was an insane use of the Light Samurai Swords went flying across the screen. And I have no doubt in my mind that FTSE will convert off of this. Oh, Knight tries to reset him, but RJ doing the EX. This is anyone's game now. Oh, that's unfortunate, he didn't convert. But there's only a couple seconds left from the clock, but I think RJ should take this anyway. And that's one apiece. That was a very back and forth match there. I wasn't sure who was going to take it, as why it went so close to the timer.
Oh, thank you, SDK, for the sub. Sub just in time to watch me lose with Zed.
So we're going into game three.
We passed it as 1-1-2 Falcon. 1-1-1-2.
Okay, so RJ's managed to hit Daishi here. He's used up both of his assists, but he drops and Daishi manages to catch RJ and Tommy. I think. Oh, I thought he was going to go into Zed there. But yeah, he managed to steal afterwards instead. Trey assists miss, and then Zed whiff. And RJ has caught it. Very nice use of the assist takeover. Oh, but he's already used his ground out, unfortunately. We are getting assist takeovers all over the place. I love it. So he's managed to just wants to release some pressure, so it's called Zord. Goes for the grab, but unfortunately it whiffed. Still got a bit of Zord left, and he should be able to punish there. And this should be a dead RJ. Oh, doesn't matter, he manages to take over Trey, and that's the Nautilus dead RJ. What a setup. Okay, we're going into super. And then he's going to do teleport to Zed. Oh, that's unfortunate. very good use of the Z standing jab there to nullify Draken in the air. Simple corner combo for Draken and effective. Very nice mix up there with the Tommy assist into the Draken overhead. Oh, but Tommy assist will still hit. I think it would be a good time to call Zord for one of the players on confirm. And I think I was going to say with the amount of meter that Draken had, he should be able to kill there. He should be able to kill Meatless now. Now Trey is going to, if he doesn't die, he's going to really struggle in this situation. Good use of pressure with the Draken Sword. That Trey into EX. So it's currently 2-1 to Rocket, so match game for Rocket. Shouldn't be able to get that much damage on Daishi right now. So, what is the mix-up afterwards? Very nice, teleport into another teleport. And he's going to attack an RJ? Of course he is. Good confirm, and now that's a dead Daishi. Oh, very nice with the RJ flip and Tommy assist. Just unfortunately didn't get anything off of it. But he's now been clipped with Zed. And if Footsies can get him, which he has, this should. Oh, missed it for the EX following. Footsie wants to get some damage quickly, so he's called Zod early. But, oh, an EX with a grab. Earlier, he's doing well to get rid of Footsie's sword. Okay, now Footsie's gonna want to go into super after this. Very nice use of the EX to cancel Zed's overhead in the air. Okay, he goes straight into super with RJ. Does he have anything after? No. Zed tries to do the snap back to get rid of some pressure. Very nice Kara grab there with Trey. And now there should be a dead Draken. Okay, super. Yep. And then he's going to tag in Zed with the teleports. Zed wasn't ready available yet. Oh, Tommy Super, which has been heavily nerfed. Oh, I was trying to see what his mix-up was there. And I think that we might be going to a final game. Zoop, zoops. He's just going to do some ambiguous dashes now. Oh, he still managed to catch him. Overhead? No. Dash with the low. Built one. Oh, it manages to flip out. Footsie is just adamant on not finishing the plate. Grab. Okay, that's one game apiece. Two game apiece, sorry. So we're going to the final match.
I can't let you run it away with it that quickly, Rocket Punch.
So, chat, who do we think is going to take this match? I want to see some ones for Footsies and twos for Rocket. Okay, so we've opened the match and Trey has caught Draken. And Trey being the master of meter building. Oh, commentator's curse. Zed just wanting to swipe the thin air mid-screen. Footsies is going cray with pressure right now. And he should be able to kill with an EX. Okay, and he goes straight into super. And he's even a... Okay, he goes to Daishi, Warpling. Same side. All the lows. Footsie is showing right now why his team is such a strong one. He's just waiting him out. Doesn't want to press any calling assist or press any buttons with the lead that he has. Manages to catch a warp wheel with Zed Star. Now if Footsies can get his combo in here, which unfortunately drops, but the Daishi assist cancels out the EX incinerate. Good punish there on the Zed. Let's see what RJ can do here with Dragon Sword. Not sure about the use of super there, but if it kills, it kills. Managed to clip him with a Dragon Sword tail with a little bit of Zord he had left. And he should... Ooh. I was going to say he should be able to punish there, but... Okay, so Footsie has Zord out now. Two characters in lead. And he should. Oh, I thought that was Rocket's final character. He's still got RJ.
Phew.
And that's now a dead. RJ. So Footsie manages to take it 3-2. Coming back from 2-1 to bring it to 3-2. So. Fair play to Footsies.
GG's Rocket. Oh man.
Made you sweat, huh?
Yeah, I mean, at this rate, he won one game, took one set off me last week, 2 weeks ago. Took two games off me this time. I think next tournament, I think the settled Rocket's going to start beating me.
Yeah, well, I was playing him the evening before last, and he said he wasn't on form. And like I was dominating well there, but then I played him again, I think it was yesterday evening, and he was doing really well, because basically the first time we played he was just getting crossed up with Tommy jump S with my assist, but he did well, like really really well, to snipe my assist every time I called them, so I was never protected. So fair play to him there.
Yeah,
but he will now fight. For some reason my web browser decided to just crash, so I'm having to load Smash GG and Twitch again.
That's always fun.
But I'll find out who he's playing against in losers. So we can finally get Giles now back, so if you want to come out for season spell can jump back in.
Back out. We can get this match started again. So currently Spag is 1-0 up.
Yep. and I think the winner of this plays Falcon.
Yeah, you can do Falcon. No, the winner of this plays Demon Slayer.
Oh, okay. No, I'm just getting my GG up now.
Do you mean on your stream or this stream, Falcon? Either way, I'm fine with that. Spag currently one game up. Cool. Yeah, that sounds good, Falcon. I just need to wait for this to load. Hopefully this doesn't end up with another jaw crashing after this again, but hopefully this will work out well.
I'm just happy that I've found a workaround to watch and play the game.
It's always good.
Yeah.
Alright, start off with some Jason guns.
Oh, into Goldar shoulder.
Nice, Chris.
Unfortunately.
Goes to a jab reset, but doesn't get anything off it. Clashing with the heavy. Let's see if Spag's got the dog combos unlocked.
But he's been clipped by Jason heavy, and now he's still got Goldar assist, so with. Oh, okay, I was going to say with super.
Yeah, he used a. You've got to be careful with Jason, because he gets some... Oh man, he's just...
Oh, and he's clipped both of them. He's just being relentless with that heavy right now.
Alright, well... He's just kind of clipping them with a raw heavy again and again. Spag's got to start blocking that.
So he's down to his last character. Oh, nice grab into the Goldar. Can he kill though?
He should be able to have Goldar, but he's EX'd quite early.
No,
so...
very early, yeah. Okay.
And he missed a little conversion there.
But, okay, I thought he might have tagged in Jason there.
Alright, well, Spag has some really excellent zoning with Slayer. You do not want to get trapped in his zoning patterns.
Sitting on a full sword, of course, as well. But, Jarl has called his.
Spag is keeping him at bay, but. Gets
there
tagged by the
That's
last one.
Wanted. Just go straight into super, but he drops it. Okay. Oh no. Okay. So he's going to probably expend every resource possible here to get that Jason 5th kill.
Yeah, this is definitely a kill because he can go into super from here. Yeah. And now he's got
and
Zord.
Now the long road ahead begins.
Honestly, he's. Got an advantage in terms of sheer zoning pressure.
Will he go into Zord from here? No, I think he's just gonna use his meter. Cross up dive.
It's a shame. Spag was really beginning to pull it back there with the Slayer really getting the zoning and the weaving
it's
in and out of the zoning.
I thought the moment he got that confirmed in the corner, he went straight into Zord.
Yeah, I think he was trying to probably save Zord for the last one. Oh no, it was Joel. I think Joel may have crashed again.
Well, that's two of it. That's two now, so I guess we could call it three if need be to just put him into losers.
Maybe. I'm just going to see if he's
responsive.
Let's see.
After this match, we should
get.
Oh, so the spaghetti. Oh well, any of the brackets. So Falcon versus Keyboard Fighter, I guess.
Yeah, it'll be Falcon versus Keyboard Fighter. Yeah. I'll see what comes next. Yeah, it's nice to still be running this on eggs. I'm always kind of really happy to run them. We got a fair few last time around this. It's been good to keep on doing this. So if you ever feel like
hopping
back on
the interest last around.
We got to about 18, I think.
Yeah. I thought it was 20.
Kaiser and Falcon went ham promoting it to people.
good stuff.
Definitely the NX. NX. Let me tell you, Daishi's got buffed. You can play him and he's going to be really good now.
What, in the last update? Or the?
Oh, yeah, yeah. In the recent update, Daishi got massive buffs. Yeah. I don't know what's happened to Joel.
I've literally not played a single... I don't play a single character that's been buffed. So... Trini got nerfed to hell, obviously, as we know.
Yeah.
Eric's been nerfed to hell with health and whatnot. And Tommy recently just got nerfed, so...
Yeah, if you could stick to playing those characters, it seems like any character you touch is slightly cursed.
Yeah.
Don't pick up Zed.
I was about to say, I might just like go through the roster of characters. I want to get nerfed.
Yeah.
It was quite funny actually. I was playing ranked last night, and there was this fighter coming across. His name's like Uchi something, and he was running Tommy, Eric, and Trey. So very similar team to mine.
Yeah.
And then after a couple of fights of beating him, he actually swapped out Trey for Trini, so he was mirror matching me.
Nice.
So yeah, it was the first time I've seen someone play my team.
It's not over yet, Falcon. Joel's apparently back now. It's probably logging. Yeah, he just boosted up the game. So this might be a bit of a slow set to run. You're waiting for loser bracket to fill up at the moment. It should fill up quickly. Once it's done, we can start running some of the matches a bit more quickly. Hopefully. I just hope that Joel doesn't disappear after every single. After every single one, I think. If he gets booted again, if he gets booted from a game again, I might get you, Spag, and Joel to run there, try and see if they can run the set off stream and finish it. So they might be able to switch you to directs, and it might be a bit more easy. Might be a bit more forgiving.
I was going to say maybe he's just doing it to increase the tournament length with the low numbers.
Maybe, but we've got Joel in again. So if he crashes out again, I'll get Spag and Joel to finish it off stream just because of just time expediency, and he might not crash.
That's if he obviously brings it back.
Yeah.
If Spag takes it, then we'll be in losers anyway.
Well, no, Joel is 1-1 at the moment.
So. Oh yes, of course it is. Yeah. Yes. I, for some reason, I thought Spag took it, but yeah, he was left on Rangers later.
Yeah, indeed. Well, let's get this going again.
Jeeves just commented it's lonely in losers. Just waiting for people to join in.
People will start showing up soon, don't worry.
If not, you'll automatically just be sent to win a grand final.
We did, in one of these tournaments, we did have a point when I accidentally got DQ'd. I actually got DQ'd all the way to winners finals. I didn't want to play a single match until winners.
Brilliant. But anyway, back to the game. So, Lauren managed to cap. Okay, so he's reset there. Ooh. Lauren's just gonna. Oh, she dropped.
Misses the cancel.
Like every time I go to say something, Udana assist just stops that doggy assist.
Going for the kicks.
Drop the medium, yep. Roundhouse for days.
Just swooping in there of Goldar.
Yeah, in and out, in and out.
Ooh.
Manages to catch Drace and assist, but assist takeover.
It's a bit of a chippy game at the moment. Both players have got Zord. Both players are at three characters. Oh, and that's big.
Lauren, yeah, because but he drops the cancel. Just raw super. It should catch though. Does he have an assist?
Ooh, the Airy X. Oh, people are just super. Throwing things out now.
They just want to get out as much damage as possible.
All right, let's see what Spag has for the incoming.
Is he going to grab him? Yep.
Nice.
Oh, God, he doesn't convert.
Yeah, it's a lot harder to get. You can convert back throw in the corner, but it's a lot more tricky.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, call the Zord.
I agree with that.
Yeah. He'll definitely get another Zord this game.
A bit of time. Yeah, and he's got a good amount of time on it to do something now with this. Oh, I wouldn't be calling that Ranger Slayer assist right now. And this should be a dead Lauren.
He's lucky to have not hit the happy birthday there.
Yeah. She's coming out with a bit less health.
Well, here we go. Spag is down.
Good use of the EX to stop the punish. Oh, but he manages to catch the slide. Always got to watch your toes against Ranger.
Misses that same thing again. I wonder if that's a Goldar Hurtbox thing, because...
Maybe.
Because that dropped at the same point as last time.
Either that or he's just pressing it too early. Playing online versus training mode, God knows.
Mm. Oh no, he's got to get in again against Slayer.
Oh, that's good. Oh no.
Slayer definitely has a superior zoning to Adana. Definitely outzones her.
That should be okay.
Oh, here we go. That should be dead.
Yeah, that should be death. Yeah.
Alright, let's see if it crashes again.
Hope not. Crossing fingers. Joel
taking it 2-1.
Spag being very conservative with his use of Zord.
Definitely.
Not pulling it.
Oh,
yeah.
No, Joel's... Okay, he crashed, so... I'm going to try and see if the two of you can try and finish it in directs. That might actually be more expedient, because it does eat up quite a lot of time. Otherwise, for now, let's get Keyboard Fighter. And Falcon to join.
Yep.
Cool.
Falcon's apparently just in training mode.
Yeah, all right, well, you can hop in a sec. Cool.
Falcon's obviously not been playing much in the past fortnight with the shenanigans that's been going on with the
PS4
version.
Yeah, quite. Making it quite difficult for a lot of people to play.
But myself included. I think I'm probably the person who's been hit worse.
Yeah, definitely. Constant crashes aren't particularly fun. But there we go. We've got Keyboard Fighter and Falcon. Had a lot of Lauren representation so far on stream.
Yeah, I think a lot of people have picked her up because she's just such a strong character. Yeah. And I think she fits a lot of people's playstyles as well.
Yeah, I think a lot of people have been sort of waiting for a character like Lauren to come.
Yeah. I mean, I'd play her if I bought the season pass, but
yeah.
I haven't yet.
Catches him with a boot.
This should...
Well, Laura's a big body. Let's see.
Yeah.
He's got the combo. He needs to have the combos to do lots of damage to get rid of the Goldar.
Okay, goes for a reset. Okay, overhead. That's a meterless kill now. Very good.
Yeah.
What's the incoming? Just he wants to back up. He's showing said a lot of respect. But the panda
Keyboard Fighter seems to enjoy backing up and incoming a lot to set up the flame
carpet.
Yeah, carpet.
Yeah.
So with Lauren, actually, Flame Carpet is a really strong incoming tool just for mix-up straight away, because it's the kind of thing that will cause your opponent to go and block stun instantly when they land.
And it is pretty much the Lauren show right now. Gen Rockets to extend, and he's going to go into Super. And that is a dead RJ.
Oof, Keyboard Fighter is showing a strong show to begin with.
Okay, and he calls Zord as well. Oh, Flame Carpet.
There you go. On the incoming, it is so strong.
Yeah. But if Falcon manages to catch an assist and call Zord, will make things interesting. But, I don't think he might even be able to get there.
Alright, keyboard fires.
Yeah.
Oh no. Nah, man.
Okay.
Very convincing first fight there from Keyboard Fighter. Yeah. Showing why Lauren is the new best character of the game.
Indeed. If you want a DQ, feel free, Bob. But let's see how it goes. Yeah,
okay, you can get, too. Let's go.
Let me get the actual bracket. Take care, Bob. Okay, let's go.
Okay, go. Holder manages to catch Lauren. And I'm sure she attacks just such a good move. Goes for
really
projectiles, covers such good range, and Hatch has such high puzzles.
Such a good move for sure.
Yeah, we're gonna see into the super again, and
oh,
that's
man.
A dead set.
This keyboard fight is running away with it at the moment.
Actually,
this will kill?
He might not be dead.
No,
no.
But.
Ooh, very good.
Nice
move.
EX.
The
yeah, nice way just to avoid some of that damage that's coming in.
Genesis picked. Locking RJ down right now.
Side switch into dog.
Yeah. Albeit raw, but still managed to catch Shaq on the wrong side. And then with super grab and EX, it should kill.
Oh, misses the grab.
Oh, no, miss.
It's day one doggy tech is learning how to hit that grab. Ooh, interesting.
Oh, went to reflect the Zed, but unfortunately too many for one.
Yeah, sad little known fact is that Zed's reflect can't really be reflected. Zed's projectile can't really be reflected.
Yeah, because it's multi-hitting.
Yeah. Oof.
Just EXs for some pressure relief. And Lauren going to flank off it there.
Oh, no.
Cancels it over the shot.
Nice.
That was a very odd scenario there with the EX.
Yeah, so he seems to have hit him with the hitbox of EX, but some of the lingering hits done also hit a Z, thus cancelling the rest
yeah,
of his
EX.
Yeah,
so it was almost like a pop-up where he could have followed there.
Almost. Kind of interesting. But those things are not the kind of things you lab for, so...
No, of course. That's one of the scenarios where you just have to make it up on the spot.
Yeah. Just having a nice
bit of neutral right now.
A bit of neutral, ooh, jumping in.
Oh, any kick could have killed him there.
But here
we go. He manages to, yep, straight into Zord, I agree with that.
Falcon is getting this momentum back, and oof.
Oh, doesn't get him there, but he's still got a bit of Zord left.
Okay, so.
Yes, yep.
There we go, that was the right play there.
And then he's got, if he just finished it off with super, that'd be a dead gem. Yeah.
Right. And Keyboard Fighter's got to be careful there, because now he had the momentum for a good bit of that fight in a previous fight. He's going to have to stop Falcon getting the momentum back if he wants
because
to.
Because Lauren was doing her dominating at the very beginning again. But
it looks like Falcon is beginning to adapt towards it. So.
Sometimes you can find that on with players as well, like they'll have three solid characters, but once they lose their point character, they just almost crumple under the pressure.
For sure, if you don't have a sort of solid character to anchor your team with, then you're going to crumple once your lead goes. Alright, what we got
okay,
here?
So it's one apiece. Paul catches Lauren there with a slide, but the gold assist miss. Genesis trying to lock him down, but Falcon being very patient. Okay, there
here
you go. Gets his confirm.
It's a double stagger with RJ Gold.
Don't want to speak too early, but this should be a dead Lauren.
It is
will
RJ.
Just go straight into super? Actually, no, doesn't need it.
Shouldn't need it. He can just probably EX. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, with the EX follow up.
Oh, we got the incoming. We'll try to go for a side switch there.
But Doggy just comes out slashing. Take him to the corner. Tiny stages. And here we go into super. Now, will he catch the grab this time?
Let's see. Oh, yeah, yes. There we go.
Okay, he might not even need the EX. No, he does.
No, he still does, just to get
just
it out.
A bit of extra damage with the gen.
Nice, because the Zordon incoming.
Oh, Shackle's still pressing buttons there.
Ooh, doesn't quite get the Zord combo. Yeah.
Genesis still out.
Nice.
Very patient for the punish there.
Little push for punish with Zed. This should be dead.
Will he go in? Yeah.
I know Falcon was definitely practicing his Zed conversions from this point.
I wasn't even sure whether. Oh.
If that has a very hard conversion to land.
He might have gone into Zord. I thought he might have gone into Zord at the moment, caught him with Zed there, since there's only one character afterwards.
Yeah, no, he's got a deal.
Just having to just wait back and. Oh, Jen just always.
Nice answer to the Goldar body splat. Little jump back aerial. It's very hard just to anti-air Goldar, so I think the avoidance was really good.
Into Zord. Tries to reset him. That's a dead Goldar.
Okay, now.
Got a bit of Zord left. Block dash.
Oh no.
This should be a dead Zed.
This should be dead if Keyboard Fighter doesn't drop this.
Yeah, he just needs to do EX into super, really. He doesn't need to do all the type of stuff.
Yeah, this should be dead from this point. Yep.
Hold it right there. And Keyboard Fighter with a really good comeback there, because that was pretty much Falcon's game.
Snatches the momentum back. Falcon's going to be on a bad...
Yeah, tilted. But that's Jen all over, to be honest. She's just such a strong character that she can easily make comeback solo.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with a Zord behind her, it just makes it even more better. She's just got really good neutral on that. She can obviously box dash, and her heavy is so good as well.
Absolutely. Okay, Jarl has taken over Spaghetti, meaning we can probably get him and Dean Slayer in.
Brilliant. I was going to say, I think she might be in the character that might be affected.
Nice.
Stage size increase.
Oh, definitely.
But he manages to catch Lauren straight away with Goldar. Oh, but he drops Zed assist. But yeah. He manages to catch the anti-air with Goldar, and that should be a dead Lauren.
Falcon in chat saying he's vexed. You can see it here, yep. Goldar coming in.
He's coming in strong.
That's definitely already. You don't often. Lauren doesn't have a lot of answers for her Flame Carpet, but Goldar is definitely a really powerful answer. That just completely negates a lot of her strengths.
Just waited Doggy out and he's put him as dead.
I think we'll probably see a reset here. Reset into overhead, but. Keep him fighting doing the jumps.
Playing very patient on neutral, though. But managed to get
really, really bad sub of the Zed so close. Because it's definitely one of Zed's laggier options at the end. I'm not sure if this will kill given a weird start, but I think it could. Yeah.
With his gen extension, it may.
Yeah, I think it will. Because he can go into assist from here. Oh, it doesn't.
Oh, it managed to not catch the second hit of it yet. But nonetheless, he manages to catch RJ on incoming.
But he's got Gem on the other side now, and that's going to convert out of it.
Catch. He's being suspended.
Okay,
so we're a bit of a deja vu scenario here.
Yeah, same situation as last time, but yep. Falcon's got a Goldar combo again.
Oh, no. Misses the air grab.
Goldar has a real problem of missing the air grab on certain female hitboxes. I think it happens on pretty much every female character.
Went for the answer, yeah, but Jen comes in strong with the heavy.
Well, it's going to be... It's got to be... It's really tilting to loot. It's definitely really tilting for a Goldar player to miss the air grab there, because it's...
I was going
to
say, Goldar's bleeding, so if he manages to catch him there, but RJ's caught, there should be a dead Jen.
There we go. Okay. Finish it with Zord. for event to come back.
So nice. Is that 2-1 now?
That's 2-2.
2-2, yeah, I wish I could remember. So we're going to the final game now.
Yeah, game number 5.
As was the last set with you as well.
Yeah, we've got a lot of, getting a lot of close sets these days.
So what was that about, Joel? Did he say that he took it over? So
yeah, Joel took it over Spag, 3-1.
Nice, nice.
See this again. Game number 5. Let's go. Getting a bit of rollbacky stuff in.
Okay, so RJ has managed to catch Lauren. He's got her in the corner.
This looks like it could be quite dominating here.
Went for the reset with Zed. Need to be able to kill.
Yeah, easy kill.
Necessary. Just straight up shoulder barges through the incoming whilst keeping Zed in.
Alright. Should be able to get this again. Yeah, will he get the end of this now?
I would really like him to. And he has. No.
Not quite. Again, it's such a weird little link to get.
Oh no, is he going to go into Zord? Oh, if he went into Zord there, that would have been a terrible punish.
Yeah.
But if he... Oh, okay, Zed did very well there. I was going to say, if he managed to kill Zed with the Zord still being out, RJ was bleeding. But his health is slowly recovering.
Okay, well, this is looking very dominating in favour of Falcon right now.
Yeah, because Jhen obviously is a strong point of Keyboard's comeback.
Ooh, but as we say that...
Yep.
This is definitely anybody's game still, because he's still got Jhen. Got plenty of blue life he can recover on the Jhen. Still got Dog, though Falcon now has full Zord. It'll definitely be a very hard thing for...
Oh, he managed to catch RJ, but it's seen on that pole. It's ridiculous.
Manages to scoot over the 2M and...
Yeah.
Oh dear, this is going to be bad.
But that's the crazy thing about her. So not only does she do that, she then comes in with a heavy and then went low. So it's just so many options at once.
Well. Ooh, nice though. Goldar eats the missile.
And is he going to call Zord? Okay. That's
definitely a dead. That's dead.
Yeah.
It was a bit... Come and go for a second.
There's going to be a big sigh of relief right now from Falcon after
definitely. Oh, that was definitely ridiculous.
Falcon saying with that Wi-Fi or what, it was messy. So we're going to be running Demon Slayer's fight now.
Yeah, see if we can get Demon Slayer and Jarl in. Yeah, you can do your loser matches off stream, Spag. Feel free. Okay, let's see if we can get Demon Slayer in. But I've not seen him about for a sec. Let's see if he's in the Twitch chat. Yeah, keyboard fighter, if you could jump out of the queue so we can get the next match going. Okay, let's get going.
Demon to jump in.
Demon, get in there. two red players in here. He's definitely an interesting set. Joel, don't see play that often, but when he does tend to show up.
The real question is, who's Jason Heavy will hit first?
That is the real question. That said, Demon Slayer has a real problem with Goldar, and from my experience playing him, so it'd be interesting to see if he figures out the matchup here, or if he spent some time figuring it out.
Okay, so Gel starting off with a bit of projectile, but Magna doing what Magna does, he just presses a button and catches no matter what's on the screen.
Oh man, we've got Happy Birthday straight off of that. This could definitely kill the Goldar.
Yep, and it has.
Oh man, that's totally rough.
Unfortunate.
And a little tag in low right at the end there.
Yep, and then another low again. Demon doing what a demon does best.
Yeah, I mean, does it very well. Ooh, miss the gun loop.
Manages to drop the gun loop. Just wasn't sure what side Udana was on there. RJ going straight with a slide. And that is a very quick first right round.
Yeah, Demon Slayer coming up strong here.
Very fortunate with his happy birthday. But Magna's one of those characters that he can,
absolutely,
if he does catch, he can definitely do damage.
Let's see if Joel manages to stay in. Oh, looks like it. May have just been an issue between Joel and Spag.
Him and Spag, yeah.
Yeah, seems like it.
Either that, or because Jarl lost the first fight, he just wanted to throw Spag off.
I doubt that.
Brought it back to 3-1.
Okay.
But anyway,
see.
Back to the match.
Oh, catches him with a jumping heavy of Magna.
No words. Lost words. But he drops it. Okay, and he goes for the low with Jason.
Oh, no. Bad time to call the assist.
And it's happened again.
That's gotta be really bad, and if he gets the gun loops here, that's a lot of damage, but luckily he only gets it on the Goldar. Interesting little thing, but Jahal is just up for his life
backing
right now.
Yep.
Yeah. He
goes for the EX, but he was expecting it. He's playing a bit patient with RJ. He's gonna slide on incoming as he does, but Goldar blocks it. Just a bit of neutral going on right now. Goes for the random EX, but he manages to get the grab.
You gotta be careful of that.
And Magna again with the just swoop.
Yeah, but we've got something going of Goldar here. Oh, we're gonna try and get.
Goes into Zord. Yep, he wants Magna dead because he is a problem.
Definitely a problem. And this will be a nice little evening up. He's got the Zord for incoming. Let's see what he gets.
Quarter left. And then he should get the EX. Yep,
oh,
very nicely done.
Nice.
And he catches the air grab. And he's got the meter now to kill.
I think he's used. Okay, good. I was going to say he's used at both his launches, but if he just goes into super, that will solve it.
And, oh, I was going to say Jarl right now with a very good Goldar comeback, but here comes Demon with Goldar sorted.
Oh, catches the jump.
He catches the air grab. Oh, that's a very unfortunate.
You don't want to be swooping in during the swords. Luckily.
But his swords run out now. Just watch your toes, I'm telling you.
Oh, we get some across it with the H. It's such a quick jump button. The new Don jump heavy. That's so good.
And then just go into super and there should be game end.
Yep.
Oh, doesn't need it.
Alright, Joel taking it up.
Very good comeback there from Joel.
Very good.
But once again, Goldar proving why he can just be such a good comeback
Goldar
character.
Goldar can just, Goldar can get the momentum and run away with the match, as we saw right there. Let's see, that is all evened up.
Okay,
Could you imagine if Golda had a projectile? It'd be ridiculous.
Technically, he does. He's got the sword stab.
Oh, yeah, of course. But here we go. Jarl coming in now with Jason against Magna. Drops it. RJ assist takeover. He's going to tag in Jason, but the Golda assist hits him.
Ooh, almost another bad assist call there. Coming in with
mid screen EX, but manages to catch it. Okay, RJ's confirmed there. He's doing very well to catch the Jason assist every time with the Golda assist.
See there, he went for the Jason jump heavy and it just got caught out by the Magna heavy.
Yeah, Magna heavy's a lot better.
Oof, Demon using up a meter. I'm not sure I agree with that. I think he could have finished it without using any meter whatsoever.
I think he just wanted them dead. Oh.
Yeah. He's going to lay the hurt down this Golda.
Grab. Yep.
There we go.
There we go. Use your Zord. That's it.
That should be a dead Jason. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, no. But he managed to cross him up for a reset. Okay. Okay, and it still confirms. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
You've always got to watch out with Demon from Wake Up EXs.
Yeah. And then this is going to be a dead Golda, and he's going to have to come back with Udonna. Without any Zord. Demon's got full Zord. Jarl's got none. He's not likely to get it back.
Demon with Slide into Slide again, but then manages to catch the Knee Crush.
Ooh. Again, the quick jump heavy. Gonna use up all that Zord timer.
Yep.
Oh, and he's just to jump out.
Yeah.
Udonna combos are always a little bit weird that way. And pressing buttons into the end. Jarl is just pressing buttons on Demon's block there, which isn't always a good thing because it leaves you really up to getting hit by EX. Demon's gonna be taking this round. Udonna out of here in dramatic fashion with a gun.
Jason EX into assist takeover is just such a simple game plan, really.
And it's really good. Jason EX is one of the easiest EXs, I think, to convert a combo off of an assist. So.
Yeah, because obviously they're still on neutral, so they're like providing you assist takeover before they flip.
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah, you can pretty much do any combo you want.
Plenty of time.
So this is match point for Demon right now.
Indeed, let's see how this goes. Okay, catches up. Jarl's gonna be just a little bit. Oh, there we go.
Patient. Yes, that's the thing with Magna. You have to always block mid screen because you have to expect that move, and then you have to expect the overhead on jumping. But in comes Jarl. Oh, but he drops the gun.
Yeah.
Assist takeover into low with Jason. He goes for another low. He's going to take over into RJ. You need to watch out for it.
Yeah, absolutely do.
See, now what I always find myself, what I try to do sometimes is you just need to press a button against the assist just in the event that they might take over. So just try and like, even if you think the assist is going to go away, just still try and hit it.
Yeah, I can see that. Ooh, very late call there.
Grab him.
You don't want to be pressing buttons like that. Demon definitely has the sword loops down.
Yeah, gold or sword loops are really easy.
Very easy, you just need a hard knockdown.
And that's...
RJEX.
The coverage of it is ridiculous.
But it's fine because we just EX straight back.
Two apiece, and
Jarl is just frightening me with these assist calls into the raw EX.
Yeah. Is he going to go Zord? Okay. Manages to not confirm. But if he can do anything after this, he's going to EX again. Yep.
Luckily, Jarl's still got some Zord left, so that helps with the incoming.
I think it's pretty much all done now. Okay, so Udonna against two characters with no Zord. It's possible.
It's definitely possible. Charles, you can't do it three just times in a row. You're going to get tagged by something eventually.
Especially Demon.
Okay, well, he's just going to go for the damage as much as he can here.
But in doing that, you're just letting Demon get Zord.
Yeah.
Which he's going to call now. He's
going to call now, and again, just managed to get the Zord out just in time, and this is looking like it's going to be a rip for...
Yeah, into Super.
Into Super, that'll do it. Bionic Dino Demon with the fist. Demon taking it 3-1.
That little fist bump there with Golda and Jason at the end.
Nice little fist bump, yeah. Cool. So let me just put in the score and put the scores. Alright, so 3-1 for Demon.
And we're going to go into the loser's bracket now.
I guess so. I think I'll probably let loser's bracket run for a bit longer and do a couple of winners' matches. Get you and Falcon in.
Now?
Yeah, I think it might be work. It might be worth.
Let's hope it works.
Hopefully.
I mean, I've been spectating, so yeah. I imagine I should be able to. But I'm just going to mute my microphone whilst I play.
Go for it. Goes. Alright, Falcon is in. Let me just update the scorecard. Grim and Falcon ready to go. You can play your matches off stream, Rocket, I think, until we get to winner's final.
So I'm just jumping back on my phone. So I've already had a freeze.
Okay.
So I think I'm in the clear, but I think it's because Falcon hasn't had a freeze yet as a PS4 player, which is why this has now occurred.
Oh, okay.
But it's now loading. Have we got a match loading, or is it because Falcon's left?
All right, let's see. So what's the fix again? Yeah. So the fix would be for Falcon to come in and just to come in again after this without opening in a way play, right?
Yeah. So if we both wait it out and we both get connection 100, we then need to just go back into the lobby and the match will run as normal.
Okay.
But if he reboots the game, then he might run into the same problem and vice versa on my end. Okay. It's now said that Falcon's left the match.
Okay.
So. Yeah, I'll go back to the main menu, rejoin the lobby.
Okay, and hopefully we can get that running.
Yeah.
Anyway, fix PS4, please. Let your players play. Yeah, so there's been a bit of a glitch on PS4 recently for people not to know, where people just kind of get disconnected.
Oh, it says Falcon's still here.
Weird.
Do I press ready?
No, wait, it should maybe, it might be broken. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna close down the lobby and open it up again.
Yeah.
Create new lobby, 1112. People join in there.
See, now, that's why, so what I find is a good thing, because it's quite weird that the glitch with lobbies, it's you get a more of a permanent freeze versus on rank. So when it's on ranked, it's easy to just wait it out, and then thereafter, you can just then play as normal, whether it's on ranked or on lobby.
Yeah.
But when it's on lobby and you actually freeze and one of the players has to quit, you then might run into the same problem again.
Yeah, it's really annoying. Really weird as well. Let's see if we can get this running again. So do we have the lobby again?
I'll just mute my microphone now in the event that it does work.
Yeah.
is the case. So otherwise that's going to be really unfortunate. Mega Isaac, if you want to get a match in...
I'm jumping back on the microphone now. Exactly. So this is what I find really bizarre. So basically, this has only ever happened against Falcon with me.
Okay.
So in typical fashion, when you get the freeze, like, so it'll load,
mm-hmm.
and then it freezes. Oh, actually, it's okay. I'm coming off. It's loaded.
No, Falcon says it's stuck again, so he might have just jumped out.
And I spoke too soon. We got a connection error 101. But if Falcon's still in the game and we both rejoin now, then it should fix it. What a nightmare this is.
Yeah. I think
so. My main menu currently says previous match is still in progress.
Weird.
Okay, let's go back to lobby. So it says Falcon's in progress still.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I think he might have just...
He's in progress with no one.
I don't
okay.
know.
Okay. Did he just quit the game? Because that's the thing. I think because he quits the game, it doesn't let the workaround work.
Mm-hmm.
You need to stay on the game.
Okay. So... Okay, so do you want to run this? I've lost all sound as well. Oh yeah, it's back now. That's weird. So Falcon, when you're doing that, are you getting stuck and then quitting out? Because that might be part of it.
Yeah, because for instance, on my end, I waited. I got the 102 or whatever, 102, 101. Got booted back to the main menu. Where, if the same thing happened to him, then we would have been able to run it as normal.
I think there might be a. I think you might just need to. I don't know how long do you usually have to wait for that, Karim.
In all honesty, it varies, but it's never more than 30 seconds, I'd say.
Okay.
But like, it obviously that is quite a long time when you think about it.
That's true. It might also just be a thing where it might just be if there are two PS4 players who are having a rough
That's
time.
What I was gonna say, because the beauty of it when you're doing crossplay is when it's someone who's on PC. Once they quit the game and relaunch, they don't get the issue, so the PS4 player can then play them. But then when you're stuck with two PS4 players and one needs to quit, you're almost stuck in an endless cycle, I guess.
Mm. Yeah, I get that. Okay, that's so strange. I really hope Enway gets on top of that soon. I know they're aware of the issue, but it's just such a weird and really annoying issue to have.
At least it's been documented on a tournament.
yeah, we can send that. And Falcon will have been streaming it, so we can send that to Enway hopefully, but it's just, yeah, kind of rough.
Especially when obviously the main selling point of this game, because like, not discredit to the game, but obviously it's lackluster in features, so the online experience is the biggest selling point. So to then be almost handicapped in being able, not being able to play,
it's just really
negates stupid. The point of playing the game.
Yeah, it's really difficult. All right, the future of Falcon.
What's he saying?
He's saying to DQ him.
No, why not just throw... I don't mind going into losers, because to be honest, he would have won anyway. So,
Have you tried doing directs against each other? That might... I don't know.
No. But the thing is, the funny thing is with the glitch is you can't open the Engway menu or it will actually crash the game.
Oh, yeah,
so
true.
I can't invite him. So the only way to then play is to find each other on ranked, on searching, or to do it via a lobby. So, I mean, we could both try to do a ranked match and find each other. And then hopefully if we both get booted to the main menu, then we're sorted. So yeah, casual or if you want to search on casual or search on ranked, then I'm happy to do that right now.
If the two of you want to try and figure that out, I'll play a match against Demon and we can see.
I'm just waiting to see what Falcon says in the chat, to be honest.
Yeah. I'm going to throw up another lobby just for the future.
You right there, mate?
Yeah, give me a sec. Lungs up. Lunged up.
Time of the year, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, so try catch up. So, okay.
Yeah, see if you try that. I'll play Demon for the time being. You see if you can get it shorted. You see if you can get it sorted. And in the meantime, I'll play Demon.
Okay, so it's connecting. Hopefully this is Falcon. Yeah, I've got Falcon, so...
Cool. Well, the TV, see if you can get that. I'll get Demon and myself to play in the interim.
Okay, so it's given me the saving icon, which means the match should load. But as I said, which is really bizarre, is when I get the saving icon, the icon in the bottom right corner, that means it's a guaranteed the match is going to load. And with Falcon, I get the saving icon, which should mean that, but then the versus icon just continues spinning in the center. It just continues spinning.
Nice.
So it almost goes against.
It's almost
what
like
everyone
it's,
else does. But I play other PS4 players, like G, for instance. Oh, okay, so it's loaded, so hopefully, if it's a connection error now, so it's a 101. Okay. Did you put Falcon? I will jump back on commentary for this FTSE versus Demon Player match. So, okay, so we currently have Demon with two characters, and now we have Footsies with two characters, Zed and Trey versus Red and RJ. Demon catches the EX and he catches two characters he tags into RJ. What can he make of it? Can he have two guys with both characters for the W? Drops it there, but resets with the EX Incinerate to punish the punish. Another EX there. Yeah, that was an impossible task we had there. So I believe that is 1-0 to Demon.
Indeed, 1-0 up to Demon. Let's see how this goes. See if I can have to pull up a secret Goldar.
So Demon comes in with Jason, but he drops it, but he catches the low to reset. Footsie comes in with Daishi, oh, but once again another drop. Trey assists, and once again another drop. But nonetheless, Trey has now caught Jason. And with a lot of work, there should be a dead Jason. So, Magno is currently called Trey. So, he's alive though still. Goes for the lows. Ult catches a Zed assist. But manages to get Daishi, calls Zor to just alleviate some pressure. Demon misses the boot with the Magna, so Footsie manages to punish the Zord, but he drops his Zord confirm. Tags in Trey, but Demon does the EX. Things are all over the place right now. Demon calls Zord of his own. Very good use of the swap strike, but unfortunately presses it again, so wastes two bars of meter there. Coming in with that strong overhead of Magna. Always got to watch out for it. Especially if you're pressing down back against Zord. But here comes Footsie's with the low. Drops the Daishi combo, but oh, we're getting dropped central, and he goes for another EX. It's Demon Slayer. Do you expect any more? Tags into the slide with RJ. Very good use to stop the. Forget what that RJ ignition mode. Drops Daishi combo, tags in Zed. And Demon with another Zord call. And that's a dead Zed, not looking great for Footsie's here. Oh, it just gets clipped at the end and that's a dead Daishi. 2-0 to Demon.
Yeah.
Alright. Just EX Central. Jason assist with Zed, tags in Daishi, oh, the orb keeps him safe. Punish. Okay, Zed manages to catch RJ. Moving, catches full combo, nope, misses the knee. Missing, keeps on missing the punishes against the RJ knee crush recovery.
whiff the Zed staff move there. Into Jason Launcher. Unloop combos. Very nice from Demon Slayer. Doesn't go into super though. Lovely dash grab there from Footsies. And it's time for the Pyramids game. Trey trying to introduce all of his friends into the scheme to help them make money. But the joke's on you, he's the only one who wins.
Oh. Went to punish there, but Zord had already been called. And Magna's going to just go for the easy lame Zord combo. Stand still the whole time. Grab. That's unfortunate. Goes for the EX and he manages to punish him on block. In comes Pyramids. Oh, nope. He goes into Zord. Reset and he goes into EX and he catches both. That's a dead Daishi, and now he tags into RJ to keep the combo on against Trey. And now into super. Trey should still be alive here.
What?
Goes for a snapback, but somehow still gets hit. Oh, and then he just... And another slide. No respect for his opponent.
I don't understand.
Zed drops out. Watch the slide. Okay. Goes for the incinerate again. Zed catches. He's going to go into Zord. Nope. He's just going to go for the solo combo.
I don't understand how Soul Strike whiffed. I really. What?
Oh. Drops the combo, and unfortunately, RJ takes it. 3-0 to Demon.
Okay. I'm sad.
I don't blame you, mate. I don't blame you.
Okay. Well, Demon moving on. Kareem's managed to wiggle his way into winners' finals without playing a single game.
Have I actually?
Yeah.
Bloody hell.
Just take it. Just take it.
So are we going to run losers or are we going to go into winners?
Let's just see who's playing in losers at the moment. So Bobby queued, so it'll be me and Spag.
Okay, so he advances.
I'm just going to sort out all the stuff that happened in the
intro. Yeah, lower brackets. Yeah. Has Jal played Rocket yet?
Jal and Jeef at the moment. So I think they're still playing. So at the moment, the two matches we can run are myself and Spag and you and Karim. Might as well get you and Demon Slayer. Get your match out of the way, I guess.
Cool.
See if you two can play. And then it'll be me against Spag, I guess. Until we see. We can basically run.
I'll definitely be muting my mic for this because it definitely won't be esports friendly commentary on my part.
Yeah. Well, Grid, we're not particularly esports here. Yeah. Gonna run the winners finals. Winners finals will be first to three. I think Grid just runs in the system of always running on first to three spec.
Okay, I'll mute myself now.
Let's see if it's going. Karim's been on commentary whole tournament, finally getting his hands ready to put into action. He's been spending a lot of time in a lab recently, so we'll see how this goes.
It appears to be the same thing occurring again now.
That's not great.
which is... Oh, no, I say that and it's loaded, but has it actually loaded, though? No, connection 101, so we'll try and run it again.
Yeah, try and run it again. Hopefully we'll get something. Yeah.
Hopefully it's not a situation where he's still... No, it's the previous match is still in progress.
Okay, well, I'll start up a new lobby once it's all happened.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's very annoying. Alright, create a new lobby.
It's funny that obviously the spectating bug got fixed, but it was just replaced with another bug.
It's really annoying. It's really annoying, obviously, as you can see, Falcon, it really kind of drains motivation to play on a lot of players. It's really sucky when you just get bugs like that that sort of destroy the game.
Yeah, because I was going to say, obviously, it's worse than the spectator bug, but the spectator bug means you can't watch. This means you can't even bloody play.
Yeah. Yeah, Rocket, you and Joel face off against each other. We're going to see if we can get Karim and Demon Slayer playing again. Hopefully we can get it to work. Yeah, hold on, let me just check how many matches. Actually, no, we can get the two of you playing on stream. Might as well, because we've not got that many.
Oh, well, me and Demon are here now. So
after you and Demon.
Okay, yeah.
We might as well, because we've got not a huge amount of matches left. We might as well get the rest of them on stream.
Okay,
we've got plenty of time.
Right now. I'm even, like, habitual now in that whenever I join for a match, I queue without spectate. Try and make the match work.
Yeah. Hopefully.
Okay, so I think it should work now.
Okay. Let's see if it goes right.
No, I'm convinced. So basically, once you like, it's normally how it normally works is the versus icon will load, and it will freeze a bit. And the moment you get the saving icon in the bottom right corner, it means the match is loaded. But what this keeps doing now instead is the versus icon loads, the saving icon comes straight away, which is too early, and then it means that the versus icon loading means nothing. So it's now loaded the match again, but I think it's going to be another 102.
That's really wacky.
101 this time. Bloody hell.
It's kind of rubbish for running a tournament as well. Half a match is DQ.
Oh, it doesn't say the previous match in progress this time, at least.
Well, it doesn't. Well, Dean's match is still in progress on my screen. But see if you can do it one more time.
Third time the charm.
Oh, man. And hopefully it will work out. It's weird, I've lost all music. And.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's what I said was happening to me with the background music.
Yeah, it's gone.
Mine was doing a weird thing where it was like, you only heard certain voices. So like, you heard Zoldon's voice, but then Draken's voice was like muted. It was bizarre.
That's really odd. Well, Demon, do you want to see if you can try getting it one more? Yeah, okay, there you go. This is just kind of very. Very unfortunate the way that is all planned out in terms of seeding and what have you.
Okay, so now it's being slower, so I think now the way it hits showing saving, I don't know, I'm probably just chatting rubbish.
It's a placebo, it's got to work at one point.
Yeah. Because, as you know from our conversations, like I've hypothesized so much with this bug to know how it works. So obviously, I'm constantly trying to like figure it out.
Yeah.
But yeah, now it's loading again. I think we're stuck on this, which is bizarre because obviously I've been playing all week with no issues. Okay, the match is loaded. It's not taking that long. And now we've got a 101 again.
Okay.
Okay, does Demon want to try, if he can hear this commentary, do you want to try doing casual match and see if it makes a difference?
Yeah, okay, so in the meantime, I'm going to try and... If you two can try and figure out something, See if it makes a difference. I'll see if I can queue up some losers. I'll get myself playing against Spag in the interim.
Okay, so yeah, Demon. So I'm going to go on casual and search. And then if it works, then we can just run casual matches and lock our scores off the stream.
Yeah, it's better to not have a losers match. The ever winners finals up on stream, but it is what it is. So far we've just had loads of loading screen issues. I'm going to be running up against Spag and running our match, and then we can get you can get you versus Rocket Punch on next if Karim and we don't manage to sort that stuff out. Hopefully we'll get something running. It's kind of weird
we
don't have any.
What I think we can do is if Falcon wants to jump back in, we can just say that Falcon beat me, so I'll go into losers and Falcon can play Demon or winners final, and then I'll play whoever was meant to play Falcon in losers.
Yeah. Alright, in the meantime though, I'm running against.
I'm searching for you, Demon, by the way, if you can
hear
this.
We've got the Plinkfinet. We've got the Plinkfinet with Dog. Spaggers kicking me in the shins like you wouldn't believe, building up that meter. Oh no, but he drops it at the end. Oh, I'm still dead. That's a really strong showing for Spag to begin with. Getting straight on my toes. This is a messy match. Incoming. Oh. Okay, let's see how we can do this. Daishi, come back. Come on. Alright, looks like this might be a commanding first game for Spag. Yeah, okay. Spag taking it. See if we can get a bit of a comeback.
I've just realized Demon plays another PS4 player.
Yeah.
So that's why we're getting the infinite loading again, and it's not working with my, like, hypothesis.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I'm making you talk whilst playing, didn't even realise.
It's alright. Alright, yeah, too well. And we drop a combo because we're a grid player. Cheeky little grab there. And he's gonna get the plinks all the way across the screen. Into the super. There we go. get scooped. Alright, evening it up. Nice and even. The classic South Africa-England brawl going on right now. Marks back way back to when we were starting up this tournament. Oh man, loads of just absolute junk on the screen thanks to Lauren.
Okay, it's worked. I figured it out.
Okay. Through that. Okay. Let's see if we can get Radeshi to come back. No feeling. Oh no. Drop the input. Magic! No, stay away! Oh, no! No! Not like this! Not like this! Oh, that was tragic on my end.
Okay, so I'm gonna now wait for you to like spectate, and then you can you'll be able to watch winners.
Okay, cool.
I would join your match to spectate, but I just don't want to risk it.
That's fair. I'm currently dropping combos like nobody's business.
Yeah, I would commentate on your stream, but obviously there's a delay.
Yeah, that's fair. Santia there, I'm about to get wrecked here. Man, Spag.
Yeah, there's just so much on screen right now.
I've not had a single one of those against. For me. GG's, Spag. GG's.
Okay, if you want to hop in on Spectate then and me and Demo will run winners.
Yeah. Alright, Spag takes it. Let's see, okay, yeah. Oh man, I'm salty. I'm game two. That last game I should have gotten. Oh, I'm salty at myself. GG's, though. On Spectre and you can get going. Yeah, it'd be like that.
Brilliant. Okay.
Okay, let's see if we can get winners finally running. Okay, we've got a winner's match. Let's see how we go. Okay, yeah, you'll be up after this, Rocket. But here we go. We've got the overhead from Karim. Ooh. Demon Kerr coming out swinging with a Magna. Covering himself nicely with the Eric's Sister. Karim's doing a good job of spacing himself with lots of assists right now. Just about manages to punish him for that. Very poor to do that without an assist to back it up. There we go, we've got Tommy Loops. There we go, that'll do for the Magna. Krim is coming out swinging. Alright. Oh, and he's caught him without the Zord to back him up. Now he's a poor Dickens for a Zord. He's not going to be getting a big Zord back after this. Again, Vogue managed to just about keep himself with his assists. Doing a very good job of spacing out. And keeping demons there at bay, which is really, I think, the strategy you need to be employing here. His poking will be overhead right now. But he's definitely going to be able to catch Demon Slayer low soon if he keeps on doing it like that. That one we see right now. Okay. Tommy Loops. He's got the meter. This should be an easy kill. Finishes it with the Billy Boot. Nice, commanding first game there. Really good first game there. Just keeping, not letting Demon Slayer getting any of the things off at the moment. Oof. Tried tagging the assist there. Much not to any good avail. Catching the overhead there, and again, Gunther is taking the momentum back right now. Should be able to get a kill here. Again, I've got to watch out, got to block his eyes. Okay, so we've got Archer jumping about, we've got the Zord called out in neutral, tagged with Magna Assist. Luckily, the stun doesn't quite hit. Still got Zord left for neutral. Doesn't quite convert though. That's going to be it for Zord. Managed to get a lot out of it. And so doing a good job of blocking a lot of these overheads right now. Nice! Dodges the Magna thing, but only to get hit by it again. Doesn't like people just do it again and call Zord. Got to watch out because Dinko's got a lot of momentum on his side here. Gonna have. No, that'll be it for Jordan. Ooh, just about misses the conversion off of that. And what is Dinko gonna do here? We're just standing here, and that's gonna lead to a punish. Again, the struggles of playing, Point Trini, playing solo Trini rather. Well, we get it. We get some damage in, but is it going to be in time? Okay, well he's taking care of a Magna. Ooh, this could take care of the RJ. Zordless. Oh, and he gets tagged by the Trini jumper. This is actually quite vulnerable to a lot of attacks if timed correctly. As you can see, Vera got beaten out by the RJ. 2M. Seems like evening it up. Going straight into match number 3. And even. You have no idea what I'm fighting for. Ooh, nice. Catching off guard with Trini Assist. Yeah, I think with Demon Slayer, a lot of the things you just need to do is make sure all of your moves are covered. That way, even if he tags you with something, then you will be able to have something to at least negate the combo following up. Like so. But he's really dropping the conversions off this Trini hit. Here we go, into Tommy Luke. Pulling the sword out in neutral, managing to get a hit down, getting the teabags in. Oh dear. Oh man, that may have just come at him. Oh man, and this could be a dead RJ right here. Oh, doesn't quite get that. Also doesn't quite get the get the Eric combo. Should be an easy kill here with the Eric. There we go. Doesn't even use any meter. And he catches Demon doing a random EX on wake up. This could be very well a dead Magna. Here we go, into the quantum power. Are we going to see the banana loops? Here we go. Ikarim special. Doesn't quite connect the EX though. He's going to go straight into the Goldar tag. Oh dear. That's going to be a dead Eric. Eric character with no health whatsoever. Compared to Russell character, lowest health in the game. Again, that has used up all the Zord. And, oh no. Tags him. It's going to be bad if Demon Slayer manages to net a kill here. It's going to be... going to be it for that game. Alright, 2-1 to Demon Slayer at the moment. Come on, new leader.
Really just like to say that I'm furious that Eric combo dropped. You're probably saying, why on earth am I doing the combo? But it should have killed. It should have killed. Where's Demon gone? Oh, he jumped out. Someone's there.
I think you may be under the impression that he's won that.
No, it's only 2-1.
Yeah.
But oh my god, how fraudulent was that? That was literally a guaranteed victory and I managed to just throw it to the wind.
Yeah, it is what happens.
Oh, good old Magna.
Okay, do you want to resolve this?
No, he didn't listen to me. If he said, I know, that was a practice match. Literally checked the chat above. I just joined the match to see if it would work.
Hmm.
Okay, cool. Right. I'll jump back off commentary then. He just wanted to get the W where he can.
Well, let's see if you can pull it back. All right. Let's continue. You have no idea what I'm fighting for. Search. Maximo. Right, well, we're getting some hits in here. Right now, it's just been slightly. It's just my whole load of. whole load of random hits at the moment, which I think we've been serving to give Demon Slayer a ton of Megazord meters. He's already got the Megazord, and he's already calling Megazord. Oh dear. It's a problem when you just get a lot of random hits in straight away. You get this mishmash of hits that just gives you a meter. But does manage to kill off it, which is really important because now. Basically, we're in a situation where he's been given Karim meter. Back to neutral. Ooh, and keeps on throwing out these fireballs. Eventually, he's going to get netted by the Magna armor. Okay, well, Demon Slayer is looking commanding at the moment. Gets him with a hit on incoming. There we go, the airplane on incoming, and that's not bad. Getting some of the chip in. Oh dear. Very laggy there. Some people jumping all over the place. Oh nice, catches him on the tag in. Demon Slayer obviously trying to look for a button there. Didn't quite come out in time. Wonder if he tried to go for the air. Okay. Gonna get the kill here. We have a Megazord. Oh dear, and it's going to be an easy kill for RJ to do here. He says, resetting him into the combo. He answers his Megazord with another Megazord combo, and he's got Megazord for incoming. Oh man. Demon's nearly got another Zord. We're almost going to have three Zords for Demon in a single match. Oh no, and there's the EX. EX into combo. Oh dear. Unless this somehow drops, which it won't do. That'll be Demon taking winners finals. Oh no, he hit the faraway one, it didn't do the damage. Oh no. Can Karim get the damage in before the time guns out? Oh, and he drops it. What was kill? Gets the chip! Gets the chip!
Oh my god. I had to do it. Oh, I can't believe
that
it.
That was
I
a sick it. Comeback. Oh my goodness.
Oh, bloody hell, the EX incinerate. I tried to answer yet, but it was just too late.
I'm gonna have to watch a replay of that, because somehow in mid combo he managed to get the wrong RJ super.
Yeah, the sound glitched out as well for me. It was really bizarre. But nevertheless, back to the next match. I'm going to jump off now.
Oh my goodness. Oh, let's see how this goes. Okay. He's going to be fuming after that one for sure. Again, slightly laggy option there. He gets the heavy starter, which is going to net him a ton of damage. Ooh, and re-grabs him on wake up. That's going to be a dead Tommy. Okay. Oh no, not like this. Okay, we got the grab. Okay, we're scrapping at the moment. And the tag in red. Ooh, this is not looking good. Demon is looking commanding right now. Got this. Oh, and the Demon EX. Ooh, we've got loops here. We've got Eric Zord loops. You don't see these all too often. Drop. Got to do the running away now, because that's going to happen and that's going to be
gonna
it.
Not going to lie, I thought there was going to be an Eric comeback there. I was hoping for it.
Same,
but
same.
But the Zord clipped me as I went for the down heavy.
Ah, well, Demon Slayer takes that.
Yeah, Demon doing what Demon does. EX all over the place.
Well.
He's in just mag.
He got some good reads there.
There was this one situation where I was really perplexed. But basically, Trini came in against Magna, and I wasn't pressing up back or anything, and like I was standing on neutral, and I still got hit with his jump heavy with Magna, and
yeah.
I was like, why did that just hit me?
After rewatch, fancy.
Really don't know.
Oh, we'll see. Now we can probably get Jarl and Rocket Punch in. Once Rocket Punch gets back.
But yeah, GG's Demon. Shout outs to Red Nova. Try and tell me I'm on Wi-Fi when I'm not.
Red Nova likes to go for old memes.
No, it's basically because in URC the glitch was happening,
yeah.
And they tried saying it was because of Wi-Fi. but I'm not on Wi-Fi anymore, and the glitch still happens, so
whatever. You're on stream, John. Yeah, Rocket Punch, getting there.
I felt really satisfied with my first fight with the Tommy. Like, did the full combo, then went into Zord to still.
You're playing the first fight really well. You're spacing a lot of stuff.
Tommy was really dominating, but then just after that, that's the thing. The moment you get caught with one jump heavy with Magma, the character's dead. So it just really throws off your whole game plan when that happens.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks, Unity, for the follow.
Okay.
But yeah, I'll hop onto spectate for this. And there was a scenario as well that basically I caught a Trini combo and I went for I got a bit more of an extension where with jump H I've been going to jump S and it just does a bit more damage. But I did that and then I didn't get the crouching light after, so I should have just
gone for stuff. Yeah. I'm trying to rock it. I've put in stuff for approval, but it's just taken ages. I'm going to have to make some new ones. Alright, just waiting for Joel to show up and then we can get this running. I'll throw it in here. Maybe his power out. I swear if his power went out again.
Oh god, is this Jar we're talking about?
Yeah.
Is he meant to be playing Rocket then?
Yeah. He was here a second ago. Because I told him he was on stream. Yeah, I think he might have had a quick disconnect from power. It's fine, he'll be here soon. We'll see if he's DC'd again from, or if his power's gone off again. Hopefully not.
He's just like a living 404.
He's just jumped back on the game on Steam. He should jump back into the game on Steam, so he should turn up soon. So he should be on his way.
There's us complaining about our life problems with Enway, the game not working properly, and then this guy's literally got his electricity cutting out and all sorts.
Yeah. It's fine.
First one I've played.
Yeah. Let's go. Let's see how this goes.
Let's check the bracket.
Alright, Jarl is here. And ready. Let's get this rolling.
So looking at the bracket, there's been quite a few fifth fights across the board.
Yeah, lots of close games. Really nice to see.
Because Jarl, his last fight against Chief looks like it was another 3-2. It says that Giles in progress. Okay, now it's loading. Yeah. One was a tick and one was a fist, so I wasn't sure.
Yeah, it's fine. It sometimes just takes a bit. Okay, here we go.
Okay, yeah. We're
straight in.
Now.
Right, rocket charging ignition.
Comes in God Assist. Draken manages to catch Red Ranger.
Ooh, we've got combos going now.
Yeah, Rocket's got some really nice combos with Draken.
Definitely.
Going for the full combos as well, which I'd like to see. Teleport up.
Ooh, nice. Oh, tries to go for the dirty reset, but matching the L2L
kind
of negates that.
Crouching L is just something else, isn't it?
It's very quick and it's very good. The thing I've heard about a lot of Draken mix-up is that a lot of them are somewhat fake, as in, if you know the answer, but they, most of the time, you don't see that many Drakens, so...
Relies on the unknown.
Some, a lot of the time it relies on magic experience.
Whoa, that was beautiful, though. Nice. Timing with the teleport heavy.
Yeah. And he's got loads of options to mix you up as well, so it's never guaranteed.
Yeah, with the right assist, and if Draken had you in the corner, he's a very scary character. Or went for the... I think go for the super, but still manages to kill.
Yeah. Nice.
Could use the EX into attacking. Yep. Doesn't get confirmed, though.
Ooh, the autocorrect of the Yudana EX. He does it again.
If he can convert, no.
He doesn't quite have dashes.
Catches the EX. And there should be a dead Udana.
Battle for the EX. Here we go. Rocket taking 1-0 up.
1-0. Very convincing first round as well. He had like a full team across the board.
Yeah, definitely.
Hopefully Gel's still here. Nope, and he's gone.
Oh no. Oh no.
Commentator's cursed.
Here we go again.
The players in the lobby.
Well, right now this is the only match we can play at the moment, so right now it's a good waiting game until he gets back. He's hopping into the game again.
Rocket's saying he doesn't want to play Jarl. Oh, momentum killer, yeah, I get that.
Yeah. Man. It's been really buggy right now. See if Joel can get himself back in again.
Hopefully.
Well, there's just been too many issues lately with the game.
See, now if you was like a sponsored stream, this would be a perfect time to run an ad.
There we go.
Between Joel reconnections.
Let me run that spicy Doritos ad.
Yeah.
when I get sponsored by Doritos, just wait. Just wait.
Yeah. Can't wait. Chili Heatwave adds every other match.
Absolutely, absolutely. Shilling every single opportunity.
Make sure to do a different flavour between every jar fight.
Yeah.
They had those ones where it was like shells or something, like cones. I forget what they were called. They were like some bizarre Doritos.
Hmm. Was able to make his way back in.
So, who's your most like? Who? If you could put someone in the game, who would you be your top choice?
Ooh, out of Power Rangers characters, I don't know. I'd really, honestly, a dream of mine is to have the Wolf Ranger from Wild Force and have him be a Venom function from GG.
Okay.
Because I think that would be really interesting to have that sort of zoning in the game with kind of movable projectiles.
Okay.
Yeah, because I think he gets... Because I think the Ranger gets a pool cue in the series, so you could use that for really fun sort of zoning.
I think if they were to pick like a Wildwood character, I think they'll choose probably Zenarku over Warframe though.
Yeah, I get that. He's definitely more popular.
Yeah. Interesting. So you'd go for a Wild Force character out of everyone.
Potential. Oh, there's loads you'd add. I don't particularly mind which character they add, but I think it'd be quite cool just function wise.
Yeah, I'm a Psycho Ranger. I'm desperate to have one of those characters in this game. Mm-hmm. But anyway, that's the match. We're finally here.
Finally here again. Let's see. We go. Just charging up Ignition.
RJ charging Ignition. Captures Dragon Sith, but doesn't get confirmed and tag in. Tommy Sith captures, doesn't tag in. Dragon Slide. Jason 2L just doesn't do anything after.
Oof.
Catch Ignition, no tag in though.
Yeah, he's keeping the assist with the Ignition Knuckle.
Okay, Jason manages to catch. This should be a dead with Super. Okay, he's going into EX.
Doesn't quite have the resources to do that.
Yeah.
Should have probably tagged into something like Goldar to finish it off.
Yeah, I wasn't sure whether he has this available or not.
Oh, that's true, I didn't check.
But here comes RJ.
What's RJ doing? What RJ do?
Killing. Oh, it goes straight into Seaver, which is surprising. Does it kill? Okay, just kills. Just block. Oh,
grabs
that
him.
Was crazy grab.
Must have been.
Oh, that's very unfortunate, though.
Just out of. Just
yeah,
out of
like
block stuff.
Caught me in midair. That was crazy.
Yeah. Still think Goldar is probably one of the true grapplers of this game, even though he doesn't immediately seem it. He's just so good at the grab game.
100%, 100%. I wish Trini had Goldar's grab game.
Alright, well, here we go again.
Draken and Honor. And then EX into Super. Okay, nope, goes for a reset.
Nice block on the EX though.
Doesn't confirm after all of your. Just says I'm going to call Super and chip you out.
Okay, yeah. Okay, Jarl's doing a really good job of not keeping himself grounded.
Oh, misses with the EX though. I would get Goldar out of there if I could. That's a dead Goldar. Oh no, just get him out.
There we go.
Good. And don't forget, you've got 4 Zord that you're sitting on. If he uses it now, he could potentially get another one. But RJ's clipped Udana. And he's got 4 meter base sitting on.
There we go. Into the Draken combo.
Okay.
Is he going to reset or kill? He had the meter to kill, but I think he just drops the combo.
He just drops, yeah.
Was that going to catch?
Super. It might catch. Nope. Pressing back. Very nice stop of the teleport there. Oh, but he drops it. Okay, 2v2. Cool, doesn't punish the Tommy jump S. Gonna play a bit of neutral now. Well, did it punish again? That's a dead Udana.
We're just dropping all the combos right now.
I would get Udana out if I could. She's dead. But Goldar with 4 Zord. Should have called Zord there.
Oh, a nice avoidance there.
That's dead Goldar.
Can just call Zord there. I just don't quite have Zord, but. Just kills anyway.
Yeah. I think he figured he was dead anyway, to be fair. Now the real question is Jarl still here?
Who knows? I doubt it if it's occurred again. Again, it's probably a thing where it happens with specific users. There he goes. Let's see if we can wait for him to get back in.
It's 2-0 to Rocket nonetheless.
Yeah. And then we can get the last couple of matches running. Winner of this will go up against Spag. Winner of that will go up against Demon. Winner of that will go up against Demon.
Cool.
Did you?
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
Okay.
So Jarl's eliminated, and Jarl's... Rocket goes through.
Okay, let's do that. Rocket will go up against Spagven.
Yeah, because obviously Falcon's DQ'd, so he just goes straight to Spag. Mm. And then I'll play the winner of that. So tell me, chat, who are we putting money on in this loser's semi? Press 1 for a Rocket, 2 for Spag. Yeah, you're playing again, Rocket.
Down to a top four.
We are indeed. Just waiting for Rocket to confirm.
Yeah. Right. Let's see what Spag has in store.
Who was Rocket's first match? Was it against Spag?
In his first match, no. Rocket went up against Bob in his first match.
Inch of the bracket. He played on it. Bob.
Okay, well, we've got a game going. Let's see what Spag has in store.
Being very patient at first with Lauren, walking back. Tags into Doggy with Flame Carpet. Very dirty.
Oh, here we go. We've got the dog combos.
Yeah. Oh, misses the uppercut. Here comes Draken into slide.
Trading combos right now.
This is it. Are you going to attack in Lauren? Yes, he does.
Oh, he's going to advance Flame Carpet, and that's a really hard.
Yeah,
that's really hard to figure out how to play against that. Not
oh, he drops the uppercut again. And then he goes into RJ. Another drop.
Just drop City right now.
Yeah, EU all over, to be fair.
That's true. Gotta level up a game one of these days.
To be fair, I'm a Marvel player. That's literally what was always happening.
Oh, man.
Okay, in comes Lauren.
Let's see if Lauren can get the actual kill. Yeah,
do her solo work. Doesn't need any of her teammates.
Quite.
Oh, drops a Flame Corridor, but still manages to continue after the EX hits the assist. Another EX.
Again, just load of drops right now. And just to get the continuation, as RJ does so easily.
Yeah, into he had Draken. Dino, just would have been made sense to just go straight into the Megazord.
Yeah.
Now he decides to call Draken. But EX from Lauren into Super.
Into Super.
Okay, wants to just waste that Zord time.
A ton of time there. He'll definitely get a couple of Zord activations left out of this.
Yeah.
Ooh. Maybe just one.
The delay with that Sakura move is just so dirty how you can hide behind it because it
oh,
takes
it
so long
is.
To root the opponent. Good confirm, good confirm. Now kill. Now what you've got for incoming, just dash under.
Luckily,
oh,
yeah.
He catches them, he catches them.
Oh, nice.
Don't go super. No, it's going to drop, but it'll still kill the first person at least because
yeah.
of her health. Yeah, never called Tommy super against two characters, but he manages to check her out. Oh, she catches the slide.
Watch out. You've got to really watch out against Spag's Ranger Slayer. It's definitely one of the better Ranger Slayers I've seen.
Oh, catches the jump S, but doesn't do anything after. Oh,
you do
very
not,
nice
yeah.
use of the ball,
oh,
but it
nice.
Misses.
but you've really got to close that out because you do not want to start getting drawn into the long game against Slayer.
Oh, misses the grab. Okay, good grab.
Oh, man, we're just playing.
Catches the slide again, goes straight into the sword, but presses the wrong button.
This is just a dirty old game, but oh dear.
I think if he can wait it out, he'll...
He's got to wait it out, mate.
Oh, no! Yeah, I was going to say, calls Zord of his own.
Yeah.
But that's...
I think he really could have tried throwing out some Zord counters during the block stun there.
Yeah, to be fair, generally that would have helped him there.
Unfortunate.
I think with it being like a relatively new function, you need to program it into your brain to use those more.
You definitely
do. I definitely don't.
Yeah, they're definitely really good at escaping a lot of incoming setups or a lot of pressure the opponent tries to put on. Obviously, they're baitable, but...
That's why, in my personal opinion, I think Zord counter should be separate from Zord activation, and then only have one Zord activation per match.
I don't think it should be
separate. Because then it will encourage people to use them.
I don't think it necessarily should be separate. I just think maybe if you limit Zord activation to once per match, then it will incentivize more Zord counters.
Yeah, I suppose. So if you can alpha counter multiple times, but only Zord once, fair enough. But back to the match, here comes Lauren. Drops the flame corridor. Draken just did not know where, bloody hell, and then into Doggy, drops it though.
Oh, so much Lauren going on the screen. Sets right up now. So much stuff on the screen. And he wants to really keep the Tommy in there.
Yeah, get out Draken if he can. Yep, goes into RJ. Flame Carpet still coming along, just sticks out there for days.
See if Spinosaurus just kills Snapping Tommy.
And Lauren should be able to kill him now with Mito. Nope, drops the Flame Corridor.
Ooh.
RJ clips. Come on, please finish your plate.
Oh, another drop.
Oh, drop. Come on.
And that's going to be dead RJ. Just getting drops
and
drops right now.
And Tommy's bleeding a bit. Comes in with a jump air, gets hit with the Flame Corridor. Catches the dog. He needs to do some more optimum combos with Tommy, though. Oh, that was a nice conversion there from Doggy into arrows. Goes for the EX. In comes the Zord.
Man, going for some really easy Tommy combos right now.
Yeah, not optimal at all with the loops.
Can you get
Which is
Draken
surprising
finish?
Because he's got such a good Draken with the combos that
he
does. That he should just maybe put some more work in Tommy with the lab. But then in comes Ranger Spear with the slide on incoming.
Now the Draken anti-air is really good, but it's also quite lanky if he gets blocked, as you see there.
She kills with EX, and then if she can... Oh, I was about to say, if she can catch, she can go straight into Zord to kill. Calls it anyway.
Tries to EX.
EX is still clips. Can he still convert? No, drops it.
He's catching other stuff.
Just...
Yeah.
Nah,
Spag
that's 2-0 Spag. Ranger Slayer flying across the other side of the screen in celebration. And Spag goes 2-0 up a match point against Rocket to go into losers final against myself. Let's see if Rocket can make a comeback.
Yeah.
To be fair, the first fight was really close.
Definitely.
So Rocket's got it in him.
Yeah, he just needs
he
to
just
kind
needs
of seize the momentum
drop.
Back.
Okay, good bit of neutral going on right now. Oh, catches the Lauren.
Just a slight tag on it.
Flame Carpet's still there, so you've got to be careful. Managed to deal with it well, but he dropped the Draken combo, unfortunately.
Oh man, and this is going to go into Doggy combo.
Oh, and he manages to catch the RJ assist also, but he drops it again. That uppercut's been dropping a lot for Spag in this tournament.
Yeah. catch him just the tip of Sarkar strike there.
Just the tip, yeah. Slides across the screen. Oh, and he catches the flame corridor, and this should be a dead dragon. Nope, he drops, but he catches the doggy assist. He can attack in Tommy. Nope, he's been caught. Very nice extension there.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
And doesn't even need to go into super. I'd get Draken out personally.
Oh, nice catch with a throw. Nice. Doesn't follow up.
Very nice. Yes. And that was a very dirty conversion with the slide into Tommy assist.
Ooh, used up one too many.
Oh, yeah, too many. Because Tommy, yeah, Tommy used the ground bounce with the slide at the same time.
Oh.
Goes for the EX.
EX to super. This should be a kill.
Oh, no, it does.
This should be a kill.
I thought Zord was going to get in the way.
Another drop.
Oh, he drops it. Bag calls Goldar. Okay. Yep, just going to eat. Oh, no! What is going on? But she's going to come out bleeding nonetheless.
Yep, there we go. Alright.
And Rocket brings it back.
Rocket is
2-1.
Edging it back here.
And also, very convincing round from him.
Definitely. Definitely.
You're a cover bro, I've got commentary.
Yeah, just getting there. Alright.
Okay, so loads of things flying across the screen at the moment. Oh, manages to catch Odd. Okay, now here comes Doggy.
Let's see if Spar can get a combo going with Doggy here.
Just don't drop the uppercut.
Oh no, he didn't drop the uppercut. He tried, I think, to go for a restand there. No, he went for a restand and just kind of... end up dropping. Oof.
Back was Plink Infinite against you.
Oh yeah.
It's not that. Yeah. Needs to do the same there.
Maybe the connection's not quite allowing it. Rocket was saying he's getting some heavy audio lag on his end.
Oh. Yeah, I think maybe the connection's just not great between the two.
We've just been seeing so many drops during the set.
Yeah, I think that might be the reason why, because that was a scenario there where Draken just stood still, so it's probably an input that just didn't get read. As I know happens all too often in this game.
Yeah. Oh, nice teleport
that was
there.
Very dirty.
Nice
and
teleport.
And Rocket looking very convincing right now.
Ooh. Oh, catches him with the tip of the EX there.
Super? Nope. Wants to hold onto his meter still. He's managed to build Zord. Oh, that was a very nice anti-air by Ranger.
Catch.
But he managed to drop it.
Rule EX there.
Or reset, shall we say.
Now, one of them's going to want to call Zord soon. Yeah, especially Rocket, because there's
and
a good
Rocket's
shot.
The first one to do it. Yep, yeah, it's just dominating position.
You want to be calling up when you've got when you've got the life to spare. There we go.
Manages to catch her, yep.
Jails her with the RJ.
Going to super, yep. It won't kill, but it'll
be
bleeding.
On.
I'll go for a grab there. Oh, very nice.
Nice, nice.
And Rocket's managed to bring it back to 2-2.
Indeed.
Final game. Yet another one.
Keeping it close. Keeping it very close.
Okay, chat, now I want you guys to tell me who do you think's gonna have it. Press 1 for Rocket, 2 for Spec.
Okay, let's see what we got here. Neutral jump of the RJ.
Oh, Lauren starting off, catching RJ.
But we got RJ drops responding in kind. Oh, and he catches both of them.
Will he go into super?
No, you don't want to go into super because that drops one of the characters out. So it's ideal just to try and build up a meter and go for an EX, really. Any sort of cinematic super will not work for happy birthday
situations.
Yeah,
it works in the first. Yeah.
Well, that's definitely seeming jittery on the spectator end, even.
But nonetheless, Lauren is dead, and Ranger is out, which he doesn't really want with that being his anchor right now. And she's being dealt some heavy damage right now from Draken, and he's going to go into the EX into super.
Doesn't quite have a meter going super.
Oh, he doesn't do it though.
Ooh, and that's going to be... Oh, doesn't quite get the timing on that.
And Range has managed to pick up two, but she drops, unfortunately, drops
yeah.
Tommy, and she's out of here, but she's still got Zord.
Oh, he tried to get the Blink Sphere. But now Rocket's got full Zord, going to call out now, and...
Yeah, just try and...
Oh yeah, there you go.
Yeah, whatever pressure
catches the stomp. It's so
very
hard to
cool.
avoid all the time. You've got to be so aware.
And can he kill with his RJ here? No. What's he going to do for reset?
Just go for
and
a super.
He catches the slide. You're going for super.
Rocket.
And Rocket manages to bring it back.
Bring it
two
back.
2-0 down.
Good job, Rocket.
Advancing into a loser's final against myself. Yeah, very good
there
job.
There we go. Rocket making top 3. Nice.
And GG's to Spag. Very good showing. That's unfortunate for the drops, but he did very well nonetheless.
Yeah. Lots of nice... Thankfully, with all of the drops, we got to see lots of nice neutral being played in Battle for the Grid.
Yes. That was the plan.
Alright.
Battle for the neutral. Okay, I'm going to hop out of commentary.
Hop out of commentary and get you and Rocket in. Against one another. You're playing Rocket, you're always playing from now on. You will keep on winning and keeping on playing. If you need to take 5, let me know. Okay, here we go. Rocket Punch Karim, let's get going. What was the start? Gonna start charging the RJ's. The RJ Ignition, luckily, he's got it charged. Is he gonna tag out and keep it in assist, or is he gonna use it in neutral? Let's see. Just throwing out stuff right now. Ooh, almost catches the Tommy. Nice coverage with the Eric assist there, and we've still got the RJ in. Not really found a chance to tag out yet. See where we go. This should be a dead Tommy. Just going to super and kill. Nice and easy. Still keeping on the RJ. Oh man. He wasn't expecting the RJ to hit there. That's why he tagged into the Draken. Continue the pressure. It wasn't quite there with the OGG. But we're back into Draken combos and into the grab. He just killed his assist in front of his face. That's just rude. And oh, managed to kill him. That was some of the rudest stuff I've seen. That was absolutely filthy. Okay, still got some left. Go and he catches the Eric. Eric doesn't have a lot of health. He could very easily kill the Eric here with the RJ. We're going to have some neutral being played. Karim's got full sword. Not full sword, but he's got some sword. Oh no. That'll do it. Rocket Punch taking the first match.
How did the stream look on your end at the beginning? Because like the first 20 seconds was a rollback mess.
Really?
Like, yeah, oh my god, it was horrendous. It was damn near unplayable. I don't know how it looked to you, how it must have looked to
it
you.
It seemed
then,
fine
on
your end.
So I don't know what if like the first 20 seconds looked really messy from both of us, but
maybe
there were just things flying all across the screen because it was just
that's really
yeah,
bad.
Crazy. But hopefully it fixes itself now.
Hope so. Regardless, that was probably one of the filthiest thing. It was just some of the filthiest stuff I saw from you killing Tommy in front of Draken.
And then I chipped him out as well.
Yeah. Absolutely filthy.
He just had to stand there and watch it happen.
Watched his friend get killed.
Okay, I'm hopping back out.
Draken into a reset. Oh, but he calls the Trinity Sister to keep him safe there. Let's go. We've got Tommy. Tommy on Tommy. There we go. Back into the Draken. Should. Oh, doesn't quite get him, but doesn't get the cancel, so instead he gets the end. Everyone is just hating on Tommy right now. Tommy keeps on getting tagged by people. Keeps on getting tagged right in front of Draken. Okay, well, we've got a full Megazord bar on Rocket Punch and nearing that with Karim. Let's see what happens here. Karim's now one character up. Straight away calling. Oh, nice. Pushes into the ground with the assist just in time for the Stomp to do his work. Got the grab. I thought we were about to kill Tommy again, but it looks like this is going to kill RJ if he gets the combo here. He seems to be dropping a lot on RJ, but he wants to be watching out because he's going to get chipped out otherwise. Oh man, this is going to be a lot of damage. Man, kills him with a headbutt. Oof. Evening it up. One all. It's like this isn't going to be a blowout on either side. Let's get this going again. Both players straight back in there. Let's see what we get. The overhead, but no conversions coming off it. Just gets out of it with Tommy Jumper, so nice. Tags the tree, but in turn gets tagged by Tommy, and now putting the blender a little bit here. Ooh, just backs up. Not sure what he's going for there. Probably trying to put on some pressure with the orb on wake up. Moment. get something of a dragon here. Oh man, he's just about get chipped out. Oof. Kroma's being the king of chip right now. What have we got, Tommy? Covering himself nicely there with the RJ. Nice. Tries to be expert, doesn't quite work, but he gets the happy birthday. But sadly, the combo gets dropped. Get some exhaust. Again, Quantum doesn't have a lot of health. Is that going to hit? Oof, that hits. Really early call on the super there. Doesn't even get the last Megazord call out, but he's throwing out buttons and it seems to be working because Eric is dead. And Krim pressing a button there in the air, getting clipped by the RJ. But obviously that used since it was in the air. Oh man. Again, we're just left with Tommy. Oh man. That's the last hit of Zord. All he's got left is a Zord counter. Oh, nice little confirm there on the Trini. See if he can get this kill. Just EX. Kill it. And now what? Tommy on Tommy. There's definitely more experienced Tommy here. Oh, but he catches him in Jump S. Doesn't convert. Got him in the corner, both in Monsing on any Zord. It's going to be down to who gets the hit of Tommy next. Oh, and the anti-air, the 4M of Tommy trades with jumping heavy of Tommy. And again, catch some jumping over fireball. Classic little bit of footsies. We're playing Street Fighter now, jumping over fireballs, punishing your zoning. There we go.
I'm so sad that I lost to Tommy now, man.
You're playing Street Fighter out there. He jumped over your fireball and punished you.
Oh man, a Tommy Mirror match. Couldn't like redeem my point character.
There we go.
To the
Rocket Punch.
I just bloody choked.
Rocket Punch match point here.
Okay.
Who gets to go up against Demon in Grand Finals? Well, let's take a look. Starting with a strong string, getting the Trini assist. Frim is always really good at using his assist to cover himself up. Alright. Goes for a reset. Doesn't quite get to the other side, and the jab mash from Rocket Punch means trying to beat him out there. Doesn't quite get there with the Draken though, and we're just trading combos right now. Nice little pickup with the Tommy from Grim. Making sure to say, actually, no, I am the real Tommy. That mirror match was a fluke, and I'm going to show you why. Finishing off really nicely with Trini assist. Didn't quite get the second, predict the second hit there. We're just dancing in and out right now. Oh no, and we've got the happy birthday. That's going to be massive damage unless they drop out. And he does. Always going to be careful because combos work really weirdly when you're in happy birthday. Things sometimes drop out. Ooh, and that's going to definitely whiff. Oh no. What are these? Again. Getting a lot of recovery on his Tommy. It's not going to kill the Eric. Rocket Punch keeps on going for these really early supers. Pulling out for Wake Up the X-Tag here. getting a nice little bit of chip. Ooh, that just suddenly something glitched in spectator mode there for a second. Oh, doesn't almost get some punish from the assist call. You want to get the quick EX there just to wait out the Zord time. Alright, let's go. Rocket is making this a close game here. But now now Karim is out of Zord meter and is down to Tommy again. And this should be it. Should be an easy kill here for Karim. Yeah. Into the 5S, into the super. Just to finish it off. Nice. Going to a nice game 5. Keeping it nice and I don't think
Rocket have had the birthday between me there so bad before, but I completely forgot what combo I was doing and did the wrong one.
Every set of Rocket Punch has played on stream has gone to a game 5. The man is keeping it very intense. He's getting the maximum number of games in. Enjoying his time in the limelight while he can. Second wolf wheel. Okay, we're getting some really nice little messy openings here. Nice cover with the air axis. Doesn't manage to convert anything off it. Gets the overhead there, doesn't convert, and we get the RJ slide, again not converting. Finally we get a combo. This could well be a dead RJ. There we go, super, into kill. This is going to be really hard for Rocket Punch to come back from. RJ's been putting on a lot of work, but he gets the jump S straight away. Again, oh no, that's going to kill the Drakkon. It doesn't kill the Drakkon. Rocket Punch needs to call Zord now. Okay, see if you can even this up. Doesn't quite get the conversion yet. Tommy is hanging on to life there for Karim. Oh my goodness, this is a real back and forth. But again, Karim's got full Zord now, calling it. Really good play there. Oh no, and he's left with the Drakkon. And he can get so much chip damage off here. And he finishes with the chip.
Rocket.
Oh my goodness. That was close. Kept that one intense.
I'm happy I managed to bring it back.
Kept it down to the wire there. Really good stuff. Means we're going to get the Demon Slayer.
I think I need a bit of a breather before Demon, though. Just give me...
Yeah, take five. Good games to the left of you.
That was intense. But yeah, I abused Tommy Jump S so bad. I don't even know where I am half the time.
That's definitely
with
fair.
An assist, and I just let the assist catch. And then I don't know if you notice, like, I then delay his move. So if I catch a medium, I wait before I press heavy. So obviously, like, if you press medium heavy, it will drop. So you have to delay your heavy a lot, or delay the medium to make sure you can go into the loop.
Yeah. Definitely.
But yeah, those were some good games.
Cool, well, let's see. We get a Demon Slayer in a bit. Head into Grand Finals.
But yeah, considering Rocket just picked up the game recently, he's very good at the game.
Yeah, Rocket's definitely been improving, and he's been grinding like you wouldn't believe, and he's really, you can really see it. Yeah, you can definitely see the improvement in Rocket over time. It's been going really well.
Yeah, Demon, if you want to hop on into the lobby. Oh, there he is. Okay. And hopefully it should work. Don't see why it didn't.
Yeah. If not, we're just going to have to update it or do the same thing all over again.
Oh, God. or we can just DQ Demon, just give me the W. I'll be happy with that.
Yeah, sure. No.
Okay, cool. I'm ready.
Yeah. I just can't wait for the day we're able to play this offline properly.
Yeah, me too, man.
So fun.
Alright, here we go.
Once we eventually get back to playing offline, we'll finally see who's really been dropping and who's been just being screwed by online. So anyway, let's get going. Okay, Krim and Demon. See if Krim can make a reset and adjust to how Demon's playing in the first set. Get the run back. Okay. Laggy stomp there. Again, the key of Demon, I think, that he wants to be doing is he wants to be watching out for a lot of the laggy moves and punishing them a lot more. Because Demon definitely likes to throw them out. Really good for getting reward, but overall. Ah, man, and he catches him doing a projectile. Doesn't quite convert, though. Good convert. Good there. Watches and catches for Red. Now you're going to want to watch out for his jumping heavy, as I was about to say. Again, Demon loves to come and swing with the heavy guns, which again nets him so much reward and so much damage. So you really wouldn't be watching out for that and punishing those when they come out. Again, getting a good anti-air against him is good. Room is going for the chip. Obviously that's going to get punished really badly, and a lot of that meter that he just handed to Demon is going straight into killing the Trini. Yeah, I'm not sure I agree with that super play at all. Oof. Okay. Ooh, this could be good. Doesn't quite get the super. Doesn't quite get the Megzord combo there. Okay, manages to chip him out. Now we've got a Zord again. Oh, and we get the jumping heavy. This is big. We can make a comeback off this. Oh, and he tried there to go for the chip, but forgot that Demon still just had a little bit of Zord out, and that completely screwed him. Again, if Demon hadn't had Zord, that would have been the right play, but just the time with Zord.
So Demon manages to get a Zord whilst having three characters, and then he still manages to get a Zord the moment I call Zord and do Zord on him. That's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah.
And that, once again, I was going for the Eric comeback, and then the one button dropped, which I knew was going to end up happening.
Yeah.
And I died from Zord. Oh well.
Okay, let's see what the run start ends here. Pretty cool that. Let's go. Doesn't quite kill there with the Mega Super. Catches him on re-stand there, and yeah, Fegan. Gotta watch out for the tag in low. It crosses up so well on incoming. Again, it's just something you gotta watch out for. It's kind of a really dirty incoming mix up where you can just call the Demon. He's getting a really nice Jason loops there. Not all that easy to do. Builds up really nice meeting, but he didn't end up going for the Super there. Again, you've got to be really careful there. You wanna ideally wait to pop Zord until the Supers actually pop them up, like it does there. Because otherwise you'll miss the incoming turn. Use the Frown Lance there. we're going to get some tagging low. Into the happy birthday. Oh dear, this is going to be damage. This is going to be very heavy damage. Yeah, goes for the super, gets maximum damage on Eric. And gets the grab to finish it off. Demon taking a very strong lead.
I do not understand what goes through this kid's head, man.
Well, Demon's taking the lead. Gonna have to see if Grim can make the. This is the last set, Tech Dog. This is Grand Finals.
And I need Demon's to reset the bracket.
Yeah, so you, Karim right now needs to make the reset of his life and pull a rocket punch and make the free game comeback. See how this goes. Alright, there we go. Again, I called out the assist. Krim tagged the assist and then just got slammed by the Demon Slayer. Success. Tommy combo. He's still in this. Okay, there you go. Getting a nice punish there. Baits out the EX. Oh, and he gets tagged by the armor. And then he gets tagged by the overhead. Gonna really. Okay, gotta play really defensively now. Yeah, nice tag in. Stop pressing buttons during Zord. It's not what you wanna be doing. Keeps himself safe there with the Eric assist. Oh, just about misses the Zord combo. Gets it again though. That keeps on dropping there. But then we keep on getting him into the Billy. Oh my goodness, and doesn't quite get the combo there. He's gonna watch out for Magna, gonna do his jumping H here soon. Jumpers is out of the way. Okay, now Karim's got all the advantage in the world. Gonna do a dash up to punish that off Tommy's range. He's letting Demon just advance into the corner. Luckily, he manages to get a nice hit because Demon does the big hit. Interrupts it with the quicker hit. Classic little bit of fighting game basics there. Drop the big hits and smaller hits. Seeing him there, but he's managing to drop all the stuff. And okay, good, blocks that. Krim's almost there at another Zord, and he'll get there once his Tommy gets knocked out. He's gonna have a Zord to play with, and he's gonna have to want to do it because if Eric gets tagged by Magna, call your Zord now, man. Oh man. He's just sitting there in a corner. He needs to be making some plays here, because Demon's got no meter. You can just punish the hard stuff here. Okay, good. Takes it there. Nail-biting moment there. Absolutely nail-biting. And that's going to lead to the... going to lead to the beginnings of a possible comeback here. Let's see if this happens. Jumping straight over for incoming. Again, the tagging cross-up is so so hard to react to. Again, it's a really good tool, Jason. It doesn't quite get a combo, but it's causing the quantum assist so close. That's really not that advisable, especially when you've got someone who's got as quick a combo as Jason gets, and that's going to be dead quantum almost. Again, though, that's given him a ton of Megazord meter, so I'd say tag into Trini now while you can. What do you want? I'll be getting back a lot of that. Should be a dead red. Manages to get the chip anyway. Krim is really good at getting these chip kills. Demon could have avoided that if he'd alpha countered, but he's gonna go straight in with the Zord anyway. Hopefully getting the kill here with Magna. Yeah, that'll definitely do the trick. Or maybe not. Trini's got a lot of health. And catches her with Philo. Nice use of a counter there. Avoid some of the pressure. But again, we've seen that time and time again in Demon vs. Kareem. Kareem throwing out a fireball against Magna, but that'll be Eric says to back him up, and that leads to a dead Tommy, because that's again a really poor time to call Megazord. You don't want to be using it right when you're about to get hit. It's really risky to call up in neutral just randomly like that. As you can see, that just led to the Megazord getting completely eaten. That's going to be it for Demon Slayer. Demon Slayer taking the tournament.
3-1.
Demon Slayer taking his first tournament winner.
That whole set was Demon Slayer just calling Zords. There's not much other two.
I know, there's a fair bit in there.
That's literally what one set. Zords 24/7.
You did make a really bad Zord call at the end there.
Yeah, obviously it was the wrong time because obviously I then got hit with the bullet. But yeah, to be fair, it was Eric. I was desperate. I just wanted to relieve some pressure.
Yeah.
Very well, Demon takes it.
Good job, and good game, Demon, taking his first tournament right now. Good stuff.
That move of Magnus needs to be nerfed, though. It's ridiculous, the coverage and the armor on it.
It's an anti-zoning tool, though. It does what it's meant to do, and it's really punishable.
Yeah, but when the character already has a projectile, has a really good jump heavy.
Magnus doesn't have a projectile, though. He gets his shotgun, which is incredibly short range. If you take away his 6S, he just dies to any sort of zoning.
I like the sound of that. But the thing is, it takes away zoning, but it's very dominant. Like, there's a difference between like cancelling it out well.
I don't know. I think it's a lot. Again, he was catching you a lot of it was just he was catching you in the very same situation.
So I was making sure to obviously not try to punish an assist, because obviously the moment I'm touching an assist, he'll do it. And then I wasn't calling assist for him to snipe my assist with it either.
Yeah.
And then I couldn't really throw out Tommy's S, because once again I'd get sniped.
Yeah, it's the kind of thing where it kind of negates certain options.
But then obviously you have to approach him, and then if you approach him, like, you've got to be wary of the not only the jump heavy, but obviously it's the Jason assist. The Jason assist is so much of a pain to deal with.
That's definitely true.
It's obviously tagging into the low, it's just a nightmare.
Yeah, it's just a matter of, yeah. There are definitely answers to it, and it's just a matter of kind of baiting the Magna into doing it a lot of the time. I don't necessarily think the move itself is massively overpowered. If anything, RJ is a much stronger version of it.
Yeah, it's really annoying, but it's like if this was a solo game without assist, then of course you could deal with it. But it's obviously when you have things to throw behind it as well, that it just makes it a lot more annoying to deal with.
Yeah, I'm gonna have it just happens.
GGs.
You can voice chat Demon. You're not gonna on the promise that you don't talk too much shit. This isn't the first to send Grudge Man Demon. But yeah, thanks everybody who showed up. Sorry again for lots of the technical difficulties that were happening throughout.
Yes, anyway, please fix this PlayStation 4 bug.
It would be really nice if a PlayStation 4 players could actually play the game properly. But yeah, thanks to everybody who joined in. Thanks to everybody who tuned in for the stream. Let me see if I can invite Demon. Demon wants to join in for the voice chat.
Fair enough.
Hold up, I'll send you a friend request. I need to send you a friend request on Discord, Karim, and I need to send Demon a friend request on Discord just to make sure that actually
done.
Works into a group. Okay, where's Demon? Let's see if Demon Slayer joins, what he has to say. Again, keep it clean, man.
Yo.
Yo, Demon, good job. Congrats. First tournament winner.
GG's, Karim.
GG's, man.
Making ERC proud.
Oh, I'm very proud.
Yeah.
I'm still saucy about our first game. When I hit you with that RG special, I don't know how I didn't kill you.
Oh, what with the super that went into the wrong RJ super in winners finals.
Yeah, I still have no idea how
that was. That was a really weird interaction. I've literally never seen RJ super do that mid combo before.
I've never seen someone make it to winners finals without playing a single match.
I did that a while back. I did that a while back, Grim Demon. It just happened. It's the kind of thing that happens when you've got small brackets. Is sometimes if.
How did I manage to
3-0
you?
Me? I'm garbage at the game. You know this.
Yeah, but I didn't expect to have as much ease as I did.
No, well, yeah, it happens. I didn't go Goldar.
When Zords get nerfed,
when I got two of them up, I was really expecting you to change to Goldar.
Nah, I'm happy with the team I've got now. I just need to stick with it and get used to it a bit more. I was just dropping too many combos, really. It just happened, really.
Whenever I play the tournament, I'm always shaking.
Oh yeah, I'm super shaky in tournament. tournament and organising and playing is a fun experience.
Yeah, I've gotten better at it. So, like, for instance, whenever I used to enter Marvel tournaments, I used to ask to be off stream because, like, playing on stream, it looked like I just picked up the game because I couldn't play.
Jitters is always really fun.
But I've gotten a lot better at it.
Yeah.
That's my first tournament, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, good stuff.
I think I scored it because the only reason I think I made it is because you do got eliminated.
Yeah, of course, there's no Falcon.
That's
the reason.
That's the only reason.
I mean, we've all got to grind to beat Falcon once PS4 is back to normal. And everyone can play properly.
I almost did beat Falcon. He beat me 3-2 in one tournament.
Yeah.
We need to find who was that guy I was talking about on Discord the other day?
Well, Belastro.
Belastro, that's it. Yeah, we need to find him.
No, he's in the main Discord. He's not in the EU Discord. But he's in the main Discord. He just often doesn't really have the time to play in tournament, sadly. But
oh, fair. Well, Belastro, if you ever watch this, we think you're really good, and you should join our Discord and enter our tournaments.
Yeah, he was in a couple of the previous tournaments as well. Made it to winners final against Obi-Wan way back in the day.
I haven't seen Obi-Wan about the Soul Guy in a while.
Obi-Wan's probably busy doing Tatsunoko versus Capcom.
What game?
Oh yeah, plays that game very seriously. So
port it to the Switch,
please. I've got it on the Wii actually. But yeah, anyway, I'm going to bring the stream roughly to an end. Thanks everyone for joining in. It's a pleasure as always. We'll see you again in two
in
weeks.
In
a fortnight, on Friday.
Fortnight.
Yeah.
And hopefully we'll get some more entrants next time.
We'll get more entrants, yeah. I'm going to try and push it a lot more this time. Hopefully we'll get.
I'm salty. The one tournament I don't enter is Sanctioned.
Yeah, well, we've not got the points for it yet. I need to get back to anywhere on that. But again, thanks to everyone for joining. I'm going to close up the stream now. We'll see you again. I might stream again at one point, see if we can get some lobbies going a bit later in the week. But yeah, see everyone later. Take care.